really know where he is. But we'll figure that out. Maybe. That is another mystery for us to solve. Cheating. Yes.
You're not online.
What do you mean I'm not online?
You're not online. Oh, there it is.
I had to refresh it.
Yeah, I probably have to refresh. Dead Sandwich, thank you for the host. But yes. Welcome to Dungeon Runners. We have this music playing always. So welcome, Joseph Meatball and Dan. I see you've got here early as usual. Let's go ahead and go over what we've been doing so far.
Whoever can provide a decent summary gets XP.
Alright, so
well, I'm not so well.
Hey, Mystic Streamer, hello as well. We have been traveling on a quest to retrieve magical weapons from a legendary mine that was thought to be long lost. And on our way, the people who gave us the quest were kidnapped, and we were sent to... we were supposed to go off and find them and continue that quest. But along the way, we reached the humble town of Phandalin and saw that trouble was afoot. We saw that there was a gang of people wearing red capes called the Red Brand who were terrorizing the town. And a contact that we met in town told us that they were a dangerous group. And the only way we could really defeat them is by cutting off the head. Their leader, a wizard whose name escapes me. Steve, what is the name?
Glassstaff.
Glassstaff. And so, we went around, trying to search for clues on the gang, any information we could get. Our friend Spivey, or Noah the Foreigner, encountered one of them and invited them out to a drink. That would be Frank. Frank was a friendly fellow. They got off great, but as a result, Frank was taken and beaten up by the Red Brand, only to be rescued by Pete Lubanina stand-in, Kaylin, and Milo, who heroically stepped in to stop him from being bullied. Frank, having had enough of the Red Brand's ways, decided to leave them and join us in our attempt to take on their team. We developed a plan to get into their base involving stealing or kidnapping two of the Red Brand gang members around town, taking their cloaks and capes so we could disguise ourselves as them, and enter the town, or enter the their secret base, undetected, hopefully. And so that is where we are. We are planning out how we are going to infiltrate this base, and we have a total of 3 capes, 1 from Frank, 2 from the people that we kidnapped. We have 2 kidnapped people sleeping under a bed in an inn right now, tied up with rags in their mouths. Yeah, that is what we're doing so far. How many XP is that cool. worth? Give me the XP!
That, my friend...
what he said. How much XP was that worth?
That would be worth 100 XP.
100 XP! Woo!
So you are now at 500 XP.
Woo! Nice. When do I level up?
The next level up is at 900, if I remember correctly. The thing is broken. I need to fix that. Don't worry.
Cool. Look at me.
All right. So, that is also a very accurate description of what happened.
Yeah, I'm a great summarizer. I'm a bard. I'm a wordsmith, if you will.
So, in we go. to Phandalin.
Yeah. Also, hello, Lindsay. We don't know where Spivey is. He seems to have just disappeared. Actually, he just sent me a Facebook message. Hold on.
Oh my.
Ah, okay. Oh my. Said he worked nights, so he's in bed right now. He said he'll have a quick shower and get on. So he'll be joining us shortly, hopefully. And then we'll have to deal with fixing the screens, but that'll be fine. So in the meantime, let's discuss our plan a little further. We're here at the Stonehill Inn. We've got two kidnapped people under the bed. We've got three capes, and I have a disguise kit, so I can disguise myself as a Red Brand. We were talking about taking the other people in as prisoners, disguising them as prisoners, so we can just walk in as Red Brands bringing in prisoners. Yeah. Now, guys, I think this is a good plan. I think we'll be able to make it inside, but the real problem is we need to get to their leader, and I don't know how this will convince them. We need to get our story straight, really. Because just, you know, three Red Brand guys walking in with some prisoners isn't really enough to convince them to be a reason to talk to the Grand Wizard they have, you know?
Well, I don't know. You're the man with the plan, man. I have nothing to contribute. I didn't think about this at all.
So, you, Frank, actually have been with the Red Brands for a while, so you probably know a lot. You certainly know a lot more than the rest of the party about the inner workings of the gang. So if there's anything you think you should know, speak up and I'll tell you what you do or do not know about that.
Yeah, Frank, how do people go get to meet the guy, your leader guy, you know?
So, I mean, Glassstaff isn't really that high and mighty. Like, he is their leader, yes, but there's not really much of a middleman. He's just the guy in charge, and he sends most of the Red Brands out to do the unsavory business, more or less.
Okay.
Also,
so this'll go smoothly. No matter what, right?
No matter what.
We walk in, you say you have prisoners, then what? They take us to be imprisoned?
We say,
Do we even take prisoners?
Yes, you take prisoners. We established this last time. You're the kind of people who take prisoners, no, for sure.
I'm not still a photo.
I think maybe we could say that there's something more important about these prisoners, that the boss needs to speak to them. Do you think that mentioning the spiders might get his attention?
That's actually a really good idea. Along with one other thing I was thinking of is which entrance to the hideout gets more activity, the one by the manor or the one in the forest? Would Frank know?
So Frank says that both of them are used fairly equally. It's really up to you which way you want to enter. There isn't much of a difference. The forest entrances are certainly more hidden and would probably get you further in, but it's up to you.
Was it the forest entrance that was guarded by like a weird eye monster?
It's just somewhere in the base.
Do you know if we would have to encounter the eye monster whether we went in either one? Frank? Steve? It's pretty likely we'd meet it either way. Okay.
That looked fun. We could go with my plan I talked about the other day. We just wait outside an entrance and keep whacking people until it's empty.
Just, if we could, just camp out and whittle them off one by one, but I think that other lady put it right when you said it doesn't matter how many heads you chop off, the Hydra will just grow them back. You have to go for the stomach. The stomach of the boss.
That analogy was really terrible.
That was a great analogy, and you just don't understand metaphors. You and your intelligence modifier of -1. So we could say that the prisoners are in. We could either say the prisoners are in with the spiders, or that the spiders are interested in them. That they had some kind of betrayal planned, perhaps. I don't know.
Certainly better than anything I'd come up with.
All right, let's just go with it.
Okay.
who's gonna be the prisoners?
It's currently afternoon right now. When exactly are you planning on taking the initiative and heading into the manor?
When would you say the manor is least occupied?
Probably during the day, because a lot of the red brands, that's where they sort of sleep, so
mm-hmm.
there would be more of them at night. However, they would probably be resting, or at least some form of sleep.
All right, so I say we go in the day. Who's going to be prisoners and who's going to be red brands? Frank, you obviously have to be a prisoner because they hate you.
I think
you also still have your like bloody nose from when, like bloody entire face from when they sort of like beat you up.
Yeah.
Earlier today, actually.
I think Milo might be a great prisoner, man.
I don't know, but Milo's pretty good at deception.
Exactly. That's why he'd be a great prisoner.
All right. If you say so.
Run up in my full suit of armor. It'd be a little more suspicious than a little guy in leather armor who's bound up, you know, man?
You're right. You should be free, Pete. Okay, so should we say wait, who's been seen by them?
I mean
Frank, yes.
Does Ben recall being seen by the
Ben,
very much
so. Ages ago?
Very much so. Very much so.
I mean, I've been seen, Kaylin's been seen, and so has Milo.
At this point, you're pretty sure you are known to the Red Brands.
Everyone but me has been seen, I think.
Well, I mean, there have been a lot of people in the streets.
That's true.
So.
Okay.
Seen you. Whether or not you've interacted with them, like directly, is another matter. But they've definitely seen you.
Okay. Wait. Milo's been ducking out of sight this whole time that he's been in town. So I feel like he's the best candidate to be someone who's hasn't been seen as
for a while. No, but it's still a pretty big deal.
I suppose the big man and Milo haven't been seen at all around here for the most part.
Okay. So, single Milo Pete, we will take the red brand coats, capes, and wear those. I'll be disguised specifically as one of the guys that we have kidnapped using a disguise kit. And, Kaylin and Frank will be prisoners, right?
Sounds good to me,
man. And Noah's also a prisoner.
I guess that's your plan. If you, I hope you have your head screwed on tight.
Yeah.
That sounds really bad.
This is gonna be great, guys. Yeah. Trust me. When have I ever let you down?
You've never let us down. I mean, after your show in that goblin cave, I have so much faith in you. So you know what? Lead on, man.
Okay. My friend Pete here. He has. He's a big liar. He's a bad liar at that. So I just want you to know he has no confidence in you after that incident. None of us have.
No, he actually told me that he'd done some really good stuff, and I wasn't there, and I just immediately believed him because that's just how I am.
Oh. Okay.
So,
that being known, I don't have any faith in you. After that incident, I don't have any faith.
That's okay. I don't need your faith. I just need you to keep you know, your disguise on. So, I'm going to have Spidey. Good morning there.
Hello, Spidey.
All right, now everyone's faces have moved around. Hold on.
I'm sure Lindsay will definitely approve that we're using her character as the prisoner.
Just, I mean, it's fine. You know, what else are we gonna do? You know.
Hey, Spivey, man, you got any ideas for infiltrating the hideout?
No.
All right.
Mentioning the spiders might have some sway, man. Maybe you could say you're members of the Spider-Man, and then have
members of the Spider-Man.
Yeah, members of the Spider-Man.
We're all Spider-Man. then they'll think it's we're like a singing gift card, and then they'll take us to their boss.
You know? That sounds perfect. Yeah.
No, but you pretend like you're letting these two members of the spider go in to talk to the boss. Since you're gonna be disguised as the other guy.
Wait, who's gonna be disguised as a spider?
You're disguised as a red brand, and then, I mean, you don't really have to disguise to be as part of the spider, I imagine. So just, you know, introduce as members of the spider.
Mm-hmm.
Probably better than just bringing in random prisoners.
Why do you seem so unsure about that?
That seems like a good idea. Sorry, I'm reorganizing faces right now, so I'm not.
And I'm waking up. Give me 2 seconds.
Slap yourself a little.
No, I'm not gonna slap myself.
Alright.
I'll demonstrate what you need.
1 point non-lethal damage. Okay, wait, who's gonna be the spider? But why do we have prisoners and spider?
We don't need to have prisoners, I don't think, if we have the spider.
But we can't say Frank is a spider.
Well, he can be a prisoner.
Which is it?
Just all of the above. Just add more, you know, and then we...
Just the one guy lead the entire group in. He took us all down.
Yeah, it's single man, it'd be very, believable coming from you.
I'm pretty trustworthy, I suppose, but... I don't know. I say we have one spider, two prisoners, and three red brand. The spider helped us to catch this person, and
Milo should be the Spider-Man.
Spider-Man. Okay, yeah, he's been seen the least. That makes sense. So Milo will be a spider. I suppose. And
I guess.
Yeah, you know,
are,
just
are
I
you
guess.
Supposed to be definite about these sort of plans instead of like going at it?
Listen, it'll work out fine. So Milo, you're gonna be a spider. Spivey, or Noah and Pete are gonna be Red Brand, and Kaylin is gonna be a prisoner. As is Frank. Are we good?
Yeah.
Okay. And the spider's there because he came to do business. He caught Frank and Kaylin conspiring against you while scoping out the town to see how the wizard was holding up business or something. Yeah. Perfect.
Sounds like a plan.
Okay, let's go.
Oh, I hope we don't die.
The Trezendar Manor. We can do it.
Oh gosh.
So yeah, okay. I put on the disguise kit, so I look like the guy who we captured it, in the inn. And I put on the Red Brand cloak, and everyone else, I assume, dresses up as whatever they're supposed to.
Yeah, yep, sure.
I was also a Red Brand?
I'm a beat-up Red Brand?
Yeah, you're a beat-up Red Brand. You're not wearing your Red Brand clothes anymore, because we're wearing them. But yeah. And we're going to do this.
Is he playing Frank?
Yeah, it's Frank.
Oh, sick.
Noah's your mate, Frank. Yeah. So we tie up knots around people's wrists, so they around the prisoner looking people's wrists, but like not tightly, just like they could slip out of them if they wanted to, you know.
Enough to make it look like it's there.
Yeah, and we let them keep a dagger on like their ankles or something, so they have something if they need it.
Okay.
Okay. And we're gonna go. Trezendar Manor.
Waltz on in?
Yeah, we're gonna waltz on in.
Might as well go through the tunnel.
What?
We're going through the tunnel, right?
No, I say we go through the top. I feel like the tunnel seems to be the
tunnel.
The tunnel seems to be like the underling way.
That's yeah, and we don't want to appear as underlings, right? Plus, if it's like, if plus those other underlings, plus you let those other guys live and run away, and I feel like that would be the entrance they would use. I don't want to meet them at that entrance.
But right. At the same time, you kind of know all the upper people. If you're in a group, right, you know who's the top diggity dogs. And if you just kind of walk into the top part and go, hey boys, how's it going? I don't know. I'm voting tunnel. I'm voting.
Okay.
I say under.
Alright, let's go under. We're going under. Yeah. Tunnel it is.
Okay.
So, you're going under. Could I get a marching order? Because it's a fairly thin or narrow tunnel. You're only going to be able to go one by one.
Oh, that's that narrow?
Like, it's a small tunnel that goes pretty directly into the cave.
All right, so I'll take the lead. Milo or no?
You said they're in back.
Actually, you know what? I'll take the front. I'll take the lead.
You're gonna take the lead? No, I think Milo takes the lead. I'm right behind him, holding Frank, and then you're behind him, holding Noah.
Alrighty.
Holding Kaylin? Holding Noah and Kaylin.
Kaylin went off into the woods to go hunting and just...
Okay, she's not here.
She's not...
She can guard the people who we have under our bed.
Yes, exactly. That's what she's doing. Instead of what I just said. Okay. So, that's where you're... That's what you're doing? That's...
Yeah.
I'll be in the back, I suppose.
Not quite in the back. You have prisoners behind you.
Oh, do I? Wait, wouldn't the prisoners be in front of me?
Yeah, the prisoners would be in front.
Okay, yeah, sure that.
Way more sense.
Yeah, let's go with that.
Okay.
Secret tunnel.
Secret tunnel.
So, you sort of enter this tunnel, and it gets dark rather quickly. You can see light coming from the other end. There are, like, torches, apparently, in the caves up ahead. And you enter into what appears to be a fairly naturally formed cavern.
Ooh.
With sort of man-made sort of entryways. There are currently four of them that you can see on, like, extending out from various places around the room. There's also a chasm that runs directly north through along the length of the room. It goes down roughly, like, 5 to 10 feet. It isn't that hard to, like, climb down and climb back up, but there are two bridges spanning it just for convenience.
Mm. Well, Frank knows the way around here. Or should. Mm-hmm. Which way to the boss?
Well,
okay.
They hold their captives near the old crypts. So maybe we should make it look like we're heading there before we make a mad dash for the boss.
That actually makes some sense.
But we don't want to have to actually drop off the prisoners. I feel like we should just go straight to the boss. We should be bringing the prisoners to the boss. Right?
Sure. I mean, it's not like logic. Yeah, logic, right?
But do we want to catch them by surprise? Or do we want to try and take us straight up to his door?
If we can, I'd like to get right up to his door, and I'd like to talk to him and get him peacefully. We're not supposed to kill him, also. Just capture him.
That's not a problem with me.
So, I mean, we just want to get in there peacefully and hopefully alone, if we can.
Okay. So those of you who are currently in the room, like, in the actual cavern, so Milo, Frank, and Single at this point, you can't shake the feeling that you're being watched.
Roll perception. Can I roll perception to actually find out if I'm being
you
watched?
You may. You may roll perception.
Okay. Where is my card up to?
It's that eye monster shit, man.
Roll to beholder.
10.
Okay, so what does this mean?
So,
feeling lucky.
Don't worry about the feeling lucky.
I want an attack roll, but let me check or save throw. Is this a... That's not a roll. Okay.
So, you are sort of scanning the room, and you hear a sort of, like, chittering off, like, in front of you, but you can't quite gauge where it's coming from.
Mm-hmm.
So you definitely know there's something here, but you don't know where.
Would I be able to persuade you to give me more information?
Roll persuade on the DM.
Something, what sounds like chitin, just like crawling along the floor at various places.
What sounds like what?
Chitin, like carapace armor stuff.
It seems like it's a centipedes.
Bug creature of some sort that's crawling around.
Okay, would it
let's just keep walking.
You're hearing it. You do not know where the sounds are coming from.
Would I be able to roll perception again to see if I can recognize what it is?
I'm hearing this too, right? I'll roll perception, I guess.
That'd be insight? Oh, insight, okay. Can I roll insight for that?
And so, wow.
You have a feeling. You remember Frank said that this place was guarded by some sort of eye monster. So, you have a feeling that this is probably what he's talking about. But again, you see nothing, and it is really freaking you out.
Alright, what do you do, Milo?
So, which direction am I hearing this from?
Somewhere off in this direction in the cavern.
Okay. Which direction?
North. directly north, towards the other end.
Is that the direction we're going?
Mm-hmm. Roughly.
Would we know where the other paths lead or not?
You do not, unless Frank told you.
Okay, can I...
Frank knows.
Okay, can I talk to Frank?
You may.
Okay, Frankie. Frankie boy. Frankie baby. This is Kong. Okay, so where are we going? Where do these branches patch on to?
So, you know the crypt is roughly in this direction, off to the northeast.
Okay, northeast?
So that's also likely where the prisoners are being held.
Okay. Did anybody else hear the thing that could be the eye monster? Or was that just me?
It
was the people in the front, I'd imagine.
What is Koality? Why is that there?
I noticed that too, I wasn't gonna say.
Alright, anyways.
Let's cover up something.
I hear it, but I think it's best if we just keep going.
Okay, so just keep going north when we could all just drop dead.
We won't just drop dead. He said whatever that thing was, it doesn't harm people. We just go. We just go.
Well,
Milo, we can't keep talking. We need to just go. We need to just go.
Did you hear that too?
Up towards the crypt.
Stop that, Steve.
Yeah.
Should we go north?
I think north is up towards the crypts, which was
yes.
Where they typically take their captives.
Wait, are we going to where we keep their captives? We're going to not the where they keep their captives. We're going to the boss. Do you know where that is?
Would it be a different direction to start heading towards Blasta?
Yeah. Steve?
So you all, or Frank knows, that Glassstaff sort of spends his office, more or less, is in the northwest part of the
okay.
hideout.
So okay.
The prisons are in the northeast.
Okay. So
north regardless.
Yeah, so Milo, let's just keep walking, and Frank will give us the signal whenever we need to turn, okay?
So
we can't keep talking. We don't want them to notice. We go north. North.
North. Okay, north.
Jeez. And be extremely quiet. Just...
Am I going to have to roll stealth for that?
Yes. All of you will have to roll stealth if you're trying to be quiet.
Okay, well, we're not necessarily trying to be quiet. I just mean, like... Don't talk.
Anyway.
We can walk, just don't talk. Okay, that's fine. Ben is being stealthy. The rest of us we're just walking. We're not trying to hide. I just don't want us to be talking and have someone overhear us. So Milo, just shh. Okay, now let's go. We're walking north.
Is that what that roll means, Steve?
You're very stealthy, but you're also intermingled with all of us.
So you are trying your best to be quiet, make like as little noise as possible. Having this conversation isn't really helping to that end, but if you all were quiet and didn't say much, then you could probably continue on.
Okay, more or less. We continue. Okay, let's go.
We'll start heading up the cabin.
Yeah, we go.
Okay.
North, Ben.
North. I know north.
Either across
like,
the
over
bridge
here.
Enough, or up, and then
the prisoners are over here, and the and Glassstaff is over here.
I guess if we go up there, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
All right. We're all walking along, I guess.
Yep.
Just keep dragging them.
No changes?
No changes for now, no.
Okay.
You come upon what appears to be a storeroom of sorts. There are boxes and crates and barrels filling the room. It seems like there is a few sort of instruments laid out upon on one of them, as if it was almost set up as a makeshift work table. But for what you can see, there isn't much other than what would probably be in the barrels.
I still hear the chittering coming from this general direction.
No, that has since stopped.
Alright, it must have been back at this turn we just passed.
Alrighty, we'll proceed that way.
Or, I whisper to Frank. Frank, is it that way? Does Frank know?
This is just a storeroom, right?
It seems like it, yes.
Okay, is this an entrance? Or an exit? Or some sort?
From right here, it seems like it's just a little alcove.
Alright. So, Frank,
would I be able to stealthily look through this room to see if there's anything we might need?
You may. Roll investigation.
Investigation. Okay, come on. Do it. Oh, dear.
Oh, no. That's a nat one. That is a nat one. First nat one of the game!
Yeah, but you reroll it.
Okay, can I reroll that?
Oh, yeah.
18.
Alright, so that's 18 plus 5, apparently. So that would be more than enough to look through here. Opening up the crates and stuff, you notice that inside is mostly just food, rations, provisions, and stuff. But in one of the crates, you see what appears to be, like, it's filled, like, to the brim with what appear to be, like, pelts of a beaver or some other small animal. There are about 30 of them that you can find, and they seem interesting at the very least, but that's the most valuable looking thing you'd notice.
I say, Milo, just put down the pelts. We gotta go, man.
Would I be able to suss out their importance? Any role?
Insight.
They're just beaver skins.
Insight? Well, you never know, guys.
You're right.
You'll never shine if you don't glow.
Oh, they are just beaver pelts.
Gosh darn. Okay. Well, I guess we have to go.
Okay, let's go. We're going over there. Frank, that's the right way, right? Okay. Milo, go ahead. We're all going along.
You see a staircase that leads downward about 10 feet and comes to a stop at the end of the hallway with a door on either end. One to the north and one to the south.
Okay. All right. Would I be able to perceive anything coming out, any noise coming out of either door?
So far, Ben was the only person to roll stealth. So I'm going to have the rest of you roll.
Stealth?
Yes.
Oh, lovely. I'm at disadvantage on that.
Oh, Pete, don't ruin it.
Six! All right, no one else bother rolling.
I mean, if we all get, did he roll in that one? Oh, six. I mean, if we all get really high stealth.
I mean, I wasn't trying to be stealthy, really.
Yeah.
We're just walking in casually. Why would we try to be sneaky? We belong here.
Yeah, we're
it
really
doesn't hurt.
So hot with this
it
stuff.
Doesn't hurt. Okay, so I would like to.
That's probably what you're doing.
Okay, so
would I know what is north and south of these doors?
You know that there's a sort of break room area to the south, and to the north is the office and workshop of Glassstaff.
The boss. Right?
So
can I
probably
can I,
don't
oh, want sorry.
To go into their break room.
Right. We want to go to the boss.
Can I listen in their break room? Can I just listen to see what's happening in there?
Yes, roll perception.
Okay.
I think somebody's outside the door.
So you sort of put your ear to the door, and you hear, like, very faintly, some sort of muttering on the other side. It seems like whatever or whoever is on the other side of this door is also trying to be stealthy. What you can gather from that take away what you will, but there appear to be some people on the other side of this door who are trying to listen in. Okay. So they probably know you're there.
So, like...
So they're trying to... Okay.
Like, I tell everybody, I put my finger over my nose at in their direction. And can I listen to see what's up... can I hear what's on the other side of the north door?
You don't really hear much on the north door. There isn't really much movement that you can detect. However, occasionally you can hear like the clinking of glass together, and what you can almost make out is a squeak from a small animal like a rat.
Okay, are either of these doors locked?
Are you checking them?
I check the north door, but stealthily.
So, you sort of slowly turn the knob on the north door and open it ever so slightly. It gives a little creak, but it's unlocked.
Okay.
I motion to Ben. I put my hand forward, like, go.
Stop.
Or go. No. I'm waving it
stop
forward.
Or go.
Like I'm doing a chop chop.
I open the door as slowly as I can.
Hold on, before you do that, I'm going to cast Shield of Faith on you, Ben. You now have +2 to your armor class.
Yay.
Okay.
I open the door very slowly.
So you open the door very slowly. As far as you can tell, this room is roughly as empty as you imagined. There's a work table and shelf on the western wall, just filled with books and alchemical supplies and potions and stuff. It seems whoever was in here was trying to learn the art of alchemy and that sort of realm of magic. And sure enough, from what you heard, there is indeed a rat sort of on the table. I want you to roll perception.
Me?
Yes. You notice the rat isn't so much looking around and doing rat things as it is looking directly at you. It sort of like scurries over to another part of the table and continues looking at you.
Would I be able to like perceive any sort of feeling coming from the rat by looking at it? I am
Arcana?
Insight,
Arcana,
insight check.
Nature.
Insight.
You're not entirely sure what would cause a rat to have this sort of behavior.
Okay, so it's looking directly at me.
Yes.
I look. Okay.
I'd like start walking in behind him. I start gently pushing Milo forward.
Okay. The rat does nothing to impede your entrance, but it is still looking at you.
Okay.
Is there a door in this room? Is that...
Yeah, that's a door.
Yeah.
Can I walk up to the door and listen to see what's on the other side of it?
You can.
Okay. So that would be perception.
Yes, it would.
Ooh. Can I stay right here?
No, you're a prisoner.
Okay.
And if you will,
oh wait, no, you're not
you
a prisoner.
Are staying right there. I'm gonna need you to make a perception check.
Ah, lovely. Let me roll skills. Perception. I'm really good at perceiving things. 6. Really good at perceiving things.
All right. Keep going. So you're listening in on the door with your 20. This room, unlike the previous room, there is no sound coming from it. There is nothing moving.
Is that a bad thing?
I knock on the door.
No,
you knock on the door. There is no response.
Why'd you do that? You're supposed to be stealthy. going.
We're not trying to be stealthy. We're trying to walk in like we own the place.
Okay. So would I be able to see if anything is special or out of the ordinary in this room? Can I do that?
Yes. Roll Arcana.
Oh, what's okay. Come on, Arcana. Come on, Arcana. Come on. Okay.
Ooh. Also, are you proficient in Arcana or no?
It said no.
No.
Okay. So you can see that he was messing around trying to make potions of some sort. The potions, or at least the potions that are currently in brewing, appear to have a sort of like grayish tint to them, and they're sort of translucent. Mm-hmm. But you don't know enough about magic to be able to discern anything about what.
So
that
these are like. These are like magic based, not like herbal.
These
based
are definitely
potions.
Magic based.
They're not herbal based potions, so I wouldn't be able to know. Okay.
Yes.
Should I taste it?
Should I taste it.
Would that be dumb?
I whisper to Frank. Where's the wizard supposed to be?
This is his office.
This is his office. Do you know where he would be if not here?
Do I know where he
is? No. He usually is in his office.
Okay. Frank. No, you're not Frank. I should... So, how many potions are there?
There's currently one on the brewing stand, and there are supplies for making several more on the work table and on the shelves nearby.
Okay, I'm gonna smell the potion.
You smell the potion. It has no discernible smell.
I try to pet the rat.
The rat sort of, like, runs away from you and then continues looking at each of you in sequence.
Can I drink the potion? Would that be advisable? Would that be advisable? What would I have to roll?
You may drink the potion.
I wish I was down there.
Okay, so no. Before I make that decision, what would I have to roll?
Percentiles.
Oh man.
Okay, what's percentiles?
D100.
D100.
Oh.
Why are you gonna drink a really suspicious-looking potion?
It's very curious. I'm gonna pass.
Okay. You leave the potion.
I'm gonna open the door.
You open the door. So inside, you see what appear to be the living quarters of Glassstaff proper, and there are all the accoutrements fit for a mage. There's a desk, there's a bed. It seems like the chair appears to be like set aside from the desk, as if someone had like gotten up recently, but. Other than that, you're not entirely sure.
I want to look through this room very thoroughly.
Alright. I'm going to need you to roll Perception. Or Investigation.
Perception first.
Alright, cool. So, you notice hanging around the wall, there are drapes of, like, scarlet cloth just decorating the area. It's a small writing desk. Comfortable looking bed. There's a wooden chest at the foot of the bed. But there's also a few like papers on the desk and a quill with like sitting resting in an inkwell on the writing desk.
Okay. Is there anything written on the papers on the desk?
Yes. On the desk, actually. You see that there appears to be a letter.
A letter? What is it? A? B?
Okay. Lord Albrecht, my spies in Neverwinter tell me that the strangers are due to arrive in Faladin. They could be working for the dwarves. Capture them if you can. Kill them if you must. But don't allow them to upset our plans. See that any dwarven maps in their positions are delivered to me with haste. I'm counting on you, Arno. Is it Arno or Larno?
You do not know from the spelling. It could be an I, it could be an L, you're not sure.
Would I have to roll to find out for definite?
It's Arno.
Don't disappoint me. Signed, Spider. Okay, guys, guys, guys. Single, come.
I read the letter. I read the letter. Mm-hmm. And I say, the plan hasn't changed. I say, all right, guys, I guess we just have to wait here. I say, all right, we wait here until he returns.
That is such a dumb plan. They're gonna kill us.
The plan has not changed.
We could just go hang out in the lunchroom.
They know we're here.
They were supposed to know we're here. We are here to...
I think you're muted.
Am I muted?
What? Yeah, no. I can't hear you.
Oh, is it because I'm muted?
How long have you been muted?
I'm not muted.
Okay.
I've literally just been telling Milo to hurry up. It's just...
Yeah, same.
If you guys can read it, it says, capture them, kill them, blah, 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 blah. There's people in the room I'm standing at, right?
Yes, there is.
Noah grabs a firm handle of the, you know, the door, and holds it closed.
Okay. You do so.
Okay. Pete would be behind him, right? Because...
Oh, I wanted to step in the room, so I just stepped in.
Okay, you can step in the room, that's fine.
Alright, well, okay. Noah's a prisoner,
would
but it's fine.
Would I be able to see
also,
if there are...
Can you guys kill the rat?
Why not?
As you start talking about killing the rat, you notice that it sort of like scurries down off of the table and attempts to run past you and out the hallway.
I'm gonna cast charm, channel divinity, charm animals, try and charm it so it has to make a wisdom saving throw against my DC of.
Oh, that's assuming that it's actually a rat.
Yeah.
But okay.
I mean. I'm not going to be able to use that this spell at any other point, so.
Wisdom
see if it has any sort of... it's 13. See if it has 13? Any sort of effect.
Okay. So you cast the spell, or you channel your divinity to charm animals. Mm-hmm. It sort of pauses briefly, but then continues running. Mm-hmm. Single, Frank, and Noah, if you want to, you can get an attack of opportunity off on it. See if
hell yeah.
I do nothing.
Okay.
I let it run past.
We should attack it.
Well, I mean, no. You guys have your arms tied. Your hands tied up.
So, Noah, you sort of, like, reach for your sword while still holding the door closed, and just sort of, like, stab the rat as it passes by. And you sort of, like, impale it on your sword. And immediately, like, a few seconds afterwards, you see it sort of, like, wisps of smoke start to, like, come off it, and it just disappears.
Oh, okay. Telepathy rat, nice.
Seems like a familiar. Or should I roll Arcana before knowing that?
You should probably roll Arcana before knowing that.
I'm gonna roll Arcana as well.
It seems like a disappearing rat. That was a weird rat. Huh.
Okay. Can I go back?
Wonder where Glastaff is.
Yes, Spivey, you are more familiar with...
Not familiars.
Wizards, but the types of things they can do, and this definitely seems like it would be a familiar.
Can I, like, search the desk and around the bed and all that in this
room?
Yes. That's what I did already.
Oh, well... did he roll for that?
Yeah, I rolled for that.
Oh, okay. Never
mind. That's how we got the note.
Did.
But did we all
check
the chest in front of the bed?
You
was
did
there
not.
A chest?
Okay, can I check the bed? Can I check the deck? Can I check what that is? Check the word.
Check the chest. Alright.
Check the word. Check the rhyme.
So you are looking in the chest at the foot of supposedly Iarno's bed. It is unlocked, and it appears to have a mishmash of a bunch of different loot. It seems like this is the best pickings of the Red Brand's collections over the past few months. Looking inside, there is a total of 148 gold pieces.
Oh, wow.
That's worth. Let's get out of here.
A silk pouch containing 5 carnelians.
So, oh. What are those?
I have no fucking idea. They're some sort of, like, decorative pin of sorts.
Oh, okay.
So would I be able to roll for you to tell me more about those carnelians?
He doesn't know himself.
They're not important. Please, no.
Be important.
No, let's just not.
They're decorative. The value they appear to be made out of some sort of precious metal, and there definitely seems to have been a lot of craftsmanship that went into making them.
Do they have, like, a specific design on them that seems important?
They resemble flowers, but other than that, not really.
Okay.
Are they magical?
Roll Arcana.
Okay. We're going to be here all day.
And it says to roll for everything. What else is natural 20?
They are not magical. Additionally, in the chest, you find 2 gemstone peridotes and 1 sort of large, fairly unusually large pearl.
Are those
magical? Is this a Steven Universe reference?
Wait,
it is not. It is not a Steven Universe reference.
Okay.
It just appears to be, like, treasure and loot that were the, pretty much the cream of the crop of the sort of takings of the red brands.
Are the gemstones magical? Would I have to reroll my arcana to see if they're magical?
Nothing in the chest is magical.
Nothing is magical. Okay. There's no magic.
Okay, so there's nothing of interest, there's nothing of suspicion except for that letter.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Alright.
So I'm gonna go out, and I'm going to go... Can I inspect the door from where I am? Like, try and sidestep and try and...
Inspect the door?
Literally everything.
Like, to see if there's cracks in the door from, like, where the wood...
We already know that there's people behind it that are listening to us. I go forward, I open the door.
I'm holding the door. Bugger off, mate.
Okay, never mind.
By the way, at this point, Noah, you feel that there are people on the other side trying to open the door. I'm going to need you to roll a strength check.
Oh. Oh,
this is where the classic spiv 1 comes out. Here we go.
Don't do it.
Okay, while he's doing that, then, I take some loot.
You managed to keep the door just very, like, shut tight. Yeah.
Touch shape.
I'll keep it when we're ready.
Okay.
If we want to make a jump on him, I'll...
I'll grab all those gemstones, because those seem easy to grab quickly.
Yeah, but you clean up.
We grabbed that.
Okay, we grabbed everything? Alright, cool. I take the potion from there, put a cork on it, and I say, you know what? Let's get out of here.
About the kidnapped kid, man.
And I grab a chair and I put it in front of the door so it's blocked. Can I do that?
What is that gonna do?
It means they can't open it. The door opens outward, right?
You did not check this door.
Wait, what door?
Oh, this door.
Although Noah is finding that you have to, like, pull to keep it sort of closed.
You have to pull to keep... Yeah. Oh, okay. So
it's a push for us. And I'm
yeah. Okay, I take some rope, take some rope, tie it to that door, and tie it to, like, the other door or something.
Oh, it's still in the room, by the way.
Okay, let's all leave.
Quickly,
I vote for just taking all these boys out, to be honest.
We don't want to make a fuss. We want to make a fuss.
Alright, we could fight.
It's like a word for our...
I pretend to kick Noah. I'm like, cut it out! Open the door, asshole!
Was that at me?
Yeah, it was at you.
Alright, Noah gives you the full stink eye. And then he like kicks the door open, ready to go.
Right.
You kick the door open, ready to fucking go.
Well, I'm still pretending to be one of them.
Well, I'm at the door. I don't know why I've moved. Like, where am I? Oh, you're moving me as well. Mad.
Okay.
I'm under you. Stop. Stop. I am under you.
There we go.
Okay. Go. I push him out of the way. I walk in and I go, cheers, mates.
As you move, both of them are going to attack you.
Oh, what? All right.
I need everyone to roll initiative.
Oh, man.
Nice idea.
I tried.
I mean, not really.
10. Lovely.
Ugh.
9. Not doing great.
He's gonna be taken out instantly.
Yep.
I'm rolling high right today.
The one I sent you.
Oh, man.
I'm gonna open my shield, by the way.
Wow. Only Spivey got a good initiative.
Before they said they were gonna go.
Alright, I didn't actually push Spivey out of the way, I take it back.
You can move
so,
through.
So, these two ruffians get attacks of opportunity on you, so.
No, I'm back here still.
No, come on, man. You moved it.
Yeah, I did. Alright. Yeah, I know.
So. They are going to slash at you with their short swords. However, they weren't quite expecting the door to open so suddenly, so only one of them actually connects for a total of 4 damage.
Okay. I go, whoa, what's the problem here?
The problem is you're here.
Come on, you guys know me. I'm just transporting some prisoners. Get over yourselves!
I need to roll deception on that.
18!
You see the two in the back sort of like lower their weapons a bit, but the two up front don't seem as convinced.
Okay.
Noah, what do you do?
Can I swing at them from where I'm standing?
You may.
You're gonna swing?
Yes. Yes, I am going to swing.
Swing.
I am. Oh shit, the prisoner's loose!
I wasn't a prisoner.
Alright, yeah, that'll hit.
Weren't you?
I was? No, I wasn't. No.
No, he
was.
So which, it doesn't matter which of them now, do anyway. You hit? The one to the left or right?
Oh, I guess you weren't a prisoner. There are 3 of us who weren't prisoners. Actually, 4 of us. Frank was the only prisoner at this point.
Huh?
The one on our right.
Okay. Okay.
This is a great idea.
So this one is going to sort of run in, close the gap, and after seeing Noah attack from behind, he's going to sort of swing his sword as well. And this will hit for 8 damage. You're now at 2.
Me?
Yes.
I go, wait, is it my turn? It's not my turn. Oh. Okay, never mind. I don't do anything.
This ruffian is going to sort of attack through the door at Noah. And this will hit for 6 damage.
Oh, it hits my armor class?
Yeah, it does.
19.
Pete, you're up.
I'm up. What can I do?
we got kind of.
Let me look through the spell really quickly. Oh, can I see any of them from where I'm at?
From where you are at, you can hear fighting, and you can see like this one directly like behind all like.
Oh, I can
all
see this one.
People that are there, yes.
I can.
You can.
Alright, if I can see them, then I can. Then it just like the with Sacred Flame, it just like appears where they're at. They just have to make a dex saving throw. So,
okay.
I guess I'll cast that since I can't do anything else from here. Then they make a dex saving throw. And it deals 6 fire damage if it hits. If it doesn't hit, it doesn't do anything.
So what's the target number? Is it just 1 target?
It's just 1 target. Yeah, it's a cantrip.
So the guy you see sort of like this flames just appear and engulf him a little bit, and he definitely seems a bit burnt. There's some scorch marks on his cape, which is significantly more red at this point.
I guess I'm just gonna stand here by the door and hope they get a swing in or something.
Oh man.
By the way, Speedy, I know you might get three attacks of opportunity on you, but you can move through creatures that are bigger
than you. Yeah.
So you could move through Spivey.
I yell, "Oh shit, the prisoner's loose!" And I try and run behind Spivey away.
Okay.
Attacks of opportunity.
So, two of them already reacted. That was their initial thing that they did. So, only one of them will actually attack you as a reaction. And they will miss.
Cool. I'm out of there.
Running away.
Wait, I only ran away. I can still do something else.
You can still do something.
Okay. I am going to... I'm gonna cast sleep. That usually works.
Man. Just in the room.
25. And I'm gonna cast it on, you know, I get a 20-foot cube, right?
20 feet from a point you choose.
Right. So I choose one that encompasses all of those guys. Can I do that? Are they within 20 feet? Okay, yeah.
Definitely.
Okay. How many of them fall asleep?
Just subtract from their hit points.
You hear from the other room 4 very distinct thuds.
Yes!
Ground.
Ah, man.
I'll go to town.
Oh, dear.
Well, that was easy. Everyone is asleep. Everyone's just asleep.
Can we slay them all?
No. You tie them up. Take them outside to make an example out of them.
Okay, so do we have any rope?
I've got 50.
There's plenty of rope around, probably.
Okay, wait, can we look for rope?
I've got 50 feet of rope on me, so.
Okay, fine.
Okay.
Let's tie them up.
Okay.
Oh, can we lock him in the mage's bedroom?
Oh yeah, with the chair in front of the door after we tie him up.
Depends on which way the door opens.
As you get a chance after combat sort of fades to actually look around the room, you see that there are several worn tables, or a single table, but several worn chairs around it. It seems like they were in the middle of playing cards. One guy apparently has a full, like, flush of 5 aces.
Oh, nice.
Despite the fact that it's a pretty short deck.
Wait, 5 aces?
And... around the rest of the room, there are wooden benches sort of drawn up against walls, decorated with more draperies of brown and red. It seems to be a theme in this hideout. And there appear to be
red.
Several...
Good theme.
There appear to be several more barrels and kegs of sort of in the corners of the room. You notice that a few of them are like propped over sideways, and there appears to be a tap in them.
Sweet. Booze.
You'll notice that there's a small stack of coins in the center of the table. It seems like they were betting on it, and one of the people was probably cheating.
Grab the coins. Unimportant.
The coins. There's a total of, like, 20 gold.
Alright. Not bad.
Along with what looks like a gold earring set with tiny little rubies encrusted in them.
Cool. Man, sleep is really OP. I'm sorry that fight ended so soon.
Are they tied up?
If you want them to be, and you have rope, now they're tied up.
Yeah.
Okay. They're tied up.
We're gonna. Can we move them over to the room? Oh. And lock them in. With the chair.
Which room?
The bedroom.
The bedroom.
Yes.
You may.
Alright, I help.
That'd be a lot of work for a halfling.
Can we?
Yeah, I'm fine with that. Let's move these guys in the bedroom. Tie them up, lock them in. Stuff rags in their mouth so they can't scream.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure they don't have any weapons or knives on them.
Mm-hmm.
All the good stuff you do when you kidnap someone I have some experience with.
Weapons from there. There's a total of 4 short swords. do you like take their gold pouches as well, or?
Yes. Yeah, take their gold pouches. Search their bodies thoroughly, so make sure they don't have any daggers hidden.
I'm gonna need you to roll stealth.
Stealth. Pfft. Easy. 7.
Okay. So as you sort of.
This is like after we tied them up.
This is after you've tied them up. After you sort of like are rummaging through their pockets, you find a total of 30 more gold among them.
Okay.
But as you're sort of rummaging through the pockets, this one sort of like wakes up from the jostling and sort of immediately takes a dislike to what he sees.
Okay, can I... Do like, I
what the hell is this?
Didn't we gag him?
I have a hammer. I have a crowbar.
You have a... What?
I have a crowbar. Can I knock him over the head to knock him out?
You may.
But I need to roll for that.
Make an attack roll.
I have a great axe. I can just cut off.
Roll 2d20. Actually, 1d20.
2d20s.
Roll 1d20. Okay.
R. 1d20.
Okay. You hit. I'm going to need you to roll 1d4 plus your strength.
Okay.
Your strength, not your straight score.
What?
Your strength modifier, not the score itself.
Oh.
That would be 2 plus 1, which is 3. Or 4 in this case. So you hit him for 4 damage. He doesn't, like, quite go down, but he seems to have not really enjoyed the hit nonetheless. There's a little bit of blood.
I stab him in the throat.
No.
Somehow he's still goddamn alive. Coughing up blood.
Drop my microphone for a second. Sorry about that.
Can I hammer him? Can I just hammer him?
Stop! I'm gonna stop you guys from torturing this guy who's already tied to the ground with a cloth in his mouth.
Again.
No. Let's. Hey man, we came here for the boss, not the.
And can we heal him? Can we heal
also
him?
Also, the prisoners.
Are these the guys that kicked the snot out of me?
Well, these specific guys, I don't know, Steve, aren't they?
Are these?
Roll perception. They don't. Actually, no, you don't need to. They don't seem to be the same people.
I rolled medicine and got an 11 to patch the guy up, so he's not bleeding out.
He wasn't unconscious to begin with, but you sort of patch him up a bit, so.
Yeah. Why did you slit his throat?
Alright, I'm gonna say, let's keep looking for the boss man.
Wait, no, let's bring them to the room and lock them in. That was the plan.
Alright, we put him in there, I guess.
The jostling sort of wakes up the others, but they're sort of tied up and can't really do anything about that right now. By the way, just wondering, who actually helped in tying them up and actually securing their bonds?
I mean, I provided the rope.
We all did.
Yeah, I think we all did.
This was a group effort.
Yeah.
Okay. So, they are all in the room and tied up.
Okay, can we take the chair and lock it and hopefully obstruct the door?
You take the chair and sort of prop it up against the door. It seems like it'll hold against a few people if they like try to break it down. It'll certainly impede their progress, but it doesn't seem impenetrable by any means.
Can I move the table?
We should find that one lady's daughter, man.
Oh yeah.
Roll strength if you're trying to move the table.
I'll assist.
You'll assist. Fine,
because I have
actually, it's Spidey. You should assist. Yeah. Actually, no, if you do that, no. If you do that, then everyone will know that we're here. Let's not do that.
While just moving the table, you can just sort of, like, move it into the position. It sort of screeches along the floor a bit, but you've sort of cleared out this small section of the hideout fairly effectively. So you don't seem like the only people who you feel would have heard them would be these guys. And they're locked.
Can we check this door? We
that down south?
Yeah.
Yes, you may.
While he's doing that, I'm gonna actually, before we lock up the prisoners entirely, can I want to take the potion that I got, and I want to give one of them a sip of it, force them to take a sip.
The potion that you got
from the table right here.
From the table right there.
Yeah.
All right. Which one do you give it to?
This one. Why not?
Okay. So how much of the potion do you give him?
Just a little sip. Tiny sip.
Okay, roll percentiles.
I want to see what happens.
Nothing immediately appears to happen.
Okay.
I say give him the rest.
Okay, so I roll perception.
I mean, at the very least...
With Pete here, or with Ben here.
There is no discernible difference from before or after the potion.
Okay. I guess I say I guess we wait, and we'll see how he turns out later. And he's locked up still.
Let's keep moving, single.
Okay. Hey, Pete, could you heal me a little bit, maybe? I'm hurting.
From beyond the door and off in the distance, you can sort of hear several gruff voices that are very actually familiar to some creatures you've heard previously, but they are saying, like, demanding commands in a tongue that you don't quite recognize. Actually, what languages do you know?
Wait, let me look.
Is it just Ben we're talking about?
Yes.
Only Ben can hear this?
Ben, do you
they are talking in a tongue that you do not understand. But basically, there's this brief, short, like, command, or what sounds like a command, and then laughter, like, moments later. And the cycle repeats often.
I'm gonna cast Cure Wounds on Speedy. Wait.
Thanks.
Okay. Are there any discernible, like, cracks in the door where I can get, like, the slightest little glimpse on the other side?
You already rolled Perception. That was it.
There's a small crack through the door. You see that on the other side of the door is nothing much other than a hallway and another door.
All right, let's.
And it goes back
okay.
to.
Okay.
I think we should try and get to the northeast where they said the prisoners were kept. Frank, could you lead us there?
No, we're going to the boss first to drop them off.
Nah,
we might be able to get some recruits from the prisoners, you know?
We tried going to the boss. The boss isn't here, so we're going to the prisoners.
Check what's over there in the other door.
Let's go to the prisoners.
Let's have Frank lead us to the prisoners.
Like, okay. What other door, though?
It's northeast, so Frank would know how to get there, wouldn't he? Prisoners?
Okay, I open this door very slowly, and I walk around to the hall. Oh, dear. I don't do that.
Jesus, Ben, you have no way of knowing that's there.
Yeah, that would be called metagaming.
You're going.
God. Fine, I do it.
Walk out the door.
I'm going.
Okay, no, I cautiously. Now that I see this turns, I cautiously look over on the other side.
Okay. You see a staircase. You can't really see anything from beyond the staircase.
You're very short, Ben.
I start walking just past Ben recklessly.
Past recklessly, and standing at the foot of the bridge is this weird sort of, like, creature. The most striking thing about it is this one gigantic green eye, although it is roughly your size, actually. It's sort of a medium creature. It is slightly larger than you and Milo, you being so as short as you are. However, it almost resembles like an insect. It has the standard, like, two arms, two legs, but it has, like, this sort of brown, dark, brownish-black carapace, almost, with sort of spines on its back. And it looks like it has this, like, evil sort of grin on it. That, just based on the composition of the skull, you're not sure if it can actually get rid of. It is
I go
smiling.
I go, ugh.
Well, what do we have here?
Oh, you can talk. Hey, Yeah. We've just been hanging out. There were some traitors back there we had to defeat. They're tied up. We're waiting for Glassstaff to get back.
I'm going to need you to roll a deception check.
This is not going to go well. 11.
Nope.
As you say, though, I feel like there would be more to your particular story than you let on. It sort of gives you a squint with its one green, like, emerald eye.
While this is happening, can I, like, perceive on this door?
You hear the similar sort of, like, command, pause, laughter, command, pause, laughter. They're very, like, gruff voices and almost primal.
Is there a crack in the door?
At this point, you can also hear a smaller voice and a set of a footprints sort of like in between the commands, sort of meekly sort of responding and scurrying around this room, what appears to be. There is no peephole that you can determine, but there don't seem to be that many of whatever would be in there.
Should I open it, guys?
Ben, that's not for us to say.
One thing at a time.
we're busy with an eye monster right now. I say to the eye monster, do you know where Glassstaff is? We seek an audience with him.
Glassstaff? Oh, yes. Well, he, until very, very recently, was in that room you just barged into.
It was a rat. Was he the rat?
No. No, he wasn't.
I didn't think so.
I'm surprised you would even think that.
Yeah, I mean, it didn't seem likely as, like, the rat turned into a puff of smoke and not into a full-sized wizard, but it seemed like it was worth asking.
Also, I should probably mention, you're hearing this creature, but its mouth isn't actually moving. You're just hearing this in your mind.
Ah. So, where is Glassstaff now? Do you know if we could meet with him?
Well, if you wanted to meet with him, you'd better hurry, but I believe at this point he would be long gone.
Why is that, if I may ask? Why do you keep laughing? It's really disturbing!
You barge in unannounced, and you honestly expect him to just stay. I'm very, very...
I wasn't trying to sneak around in any way.
Oh, but yes, you were. I saw you.
I did not roll stealth at all. All we really wanted was to talk to him. We did not want to fight.
Why are you putting that suggestion in his mind?
If you say so, but again, I'm not entirely convinced.
I mean, that's, like, true, though. We didn't want to fight. Mm-hmm.
And tell me, what would you seek of Iarno?
We heard news of his connection to the Black Spider.
Oh, yes, he's mentioned them quite a lot. I don't really bother for the goings-on in this cave. I'm here for a different reason, but the arrangement I have with the Red Brands is mutually beneficial.
I see. Well, we heard of his connection to the Black Spider, and we wanted to learn more. We also had a prisoner with us who we wanted to return to him.
Oh, I doubt that very much.
Well...
You have an ulterior motive.
Perhaps that is true.
Besides, that's not the only drive you have, is it? Searching for this forge of spells, as you probably know. Yes, I can see... You have heard of it.
Wait, what did he just say? Searching for the what?
The Forge of Spells.
Oh! I say...
Is it magic you seek?
Forge of Spells? I heard that was destroyed long ago.
Oh, it still exists. It still exists. I can sense it. Not quite from here, but it exists. Certainly it hasn't been destroyed.
Interesting. Would you know where to find it? We're getting off track here. We're getting off track. I don't...
No.
Really, though.
Really?
Let him
say it. Let him say it.
Ben, stop metagaming.
Give us more information.
Milo, please.
Please, give us more information, oh wise and telepathic one.
What would you say we do?
I have no say in what you do. That is up to you. However, I will say there are quite a few flaws in what you had done that I personally would have done differently. But the past is the past. Water under the bridge.
Would you be willing to tell us where Glassstaff is so we can meet with him?
As I said, he left.
Do you know where? And if we could catch up.
I much prefer the coziness of this cave. But, if I were him, escaping from intruders, murderous intruders who probably want to kill me, I would probably run as far away as I could.
We are not murderous.
Man, right?
We have heard that he was wanted, but not in the legal sense, more that someone simply wanted him to stop. Not by any legal organization or government.
Oh, but I doubt this. I am rather hungry.
What do you eat, may I ask? I don't know if I want to know the answer to this question.
As I said previously, the arrangement I had with the Red Brands was mutually
beneficial. Oh,
no. They provided protection, and I provided protection. As much as I could, anyway.
Aha. Uh-huh. So sleep.
No, man.
I can't sleep. Yes, I can.
All right. You cast a spell, and the Nothic sort of like looks at you, cocks its head a bit, and says, "Well, now wasn't that interesting?"
Oh. I back up. I'm back at the... I ran away. Wait. Get him, guys!
Oh, powerful telepathic.
Oh, no. This can't end well.
Your will with us?
I think he made that pretty clear!
No, not so much my will as my orders, but if you want to put it bluntly, I'm a distraction.
Ah! Run! I kick this door down.
Oh, you kick that door down.
That was a great idea. Oh my goodness. Roll initiative.
Get everyone to roll initiative again.
Bloody dingus, man.
Ah, four.
So you kick down the door.
Oh, that's the wrong initiative again.
Immediately, sort of like. Surprise a group of bugbears who were terrorizing this goblin, who upon seeing you immediately just sort of like faints.
Okay, I immediately close the door behind me.
You close the door behind you.
I say, sorry, wrong room. Carry on.
I want you to roll persuasion.
10? Oh, wait. I have inspiration, right?
You can't inspire yourself. That is not a thing.
Well, not bardic inspiration. I have a regular inspiration.
Well.
You may.
Alright. Cool. 19!
From what you saw on their faces as you, like, hastily closed the door, you are wearing a red, like, cape, by the way, as well.
Right. Yeah.
They had a look of confusion, but they just sort of, like, huffed and turned back to terrorizing the now fainted
zombie. Man, that's good, because I rolled a 3 for initiative. Okay. Alright, cool. No combat there. I say, alright, guys, ditch this creepy monster thing. Let's go. This is clearly a distraction.
Wait.
I start running past him.
Okay. You start running past him.
Let's go.
Now, initiative.
Oh, okay.
Wait. Are
we rerolling initiative?
No, you're good with the initiative you rolled.
Oh, never mind. Nat 1 initiative. As I'm running past this guy.
So as you're running past, you sort of see the Nothic sort of reach out with its claws and just sort of like scrape you as you're running past. And you get hit with 5 slashing damage.
Oh man, that hurts. Can I be like running past him so that's like his attack of opportunity?
Yes, or whatever? That is his attack of opportunity.
Okay, so I'm like past him now, over here. I'm running this way. Wait, should I be? Oh, I'm running this way. I don't care. Well, that was entering combat. This is how we entered combat, was me running past this guy.
Yeah.
Right?
That much room? Move.
You know.
Yeah.
That was a long bloody way.
Sure. I mean, we weren't in combat, so I can move as much as I want. We weren't taking turns.
I'm gonna say you were like right here, and then you made a break for it.
Okay.
I'm probably fine.
If you got hit by the creature, you have to stop next to her.
I don't know.
Well, this is wonderful.
Alright.
Now, tell me, quite quickly, where do you think you're going?
I say, away from you, because you make me really uncomfortable.
It's an effect I have.
Okay. Whose turn is it?
I would rather we not do this. It's currently still your turn if you want to make an action.
Oh. Can I move still?
Go to sleep.
I can't cast sleep again or anything else. I say, then just let us go, and we won't, you know, we won't do anything to hurt you.
Oh, of that I have no doubt. Besides, I've probably kept you long enough, haven't I?
Yeah, so you're gonna leave us alone now?
It depends.
On what?
On what you do.
What is that? I say, that's quite enough. I think there's only one thing left to do. There's one way to bring you to our side, and that's with the power of rock and roll.
Oh,
I just played the guitar so it's noise if you couldn't hear. So I start playing like the heaviest rock and roll, like heavy metal music.
Total distortion.
Yeah, just like super heavy, but like with really clean vocals. About. Yeah. Okay. 7. No! Why can't I ever get a good performance roll?
You never got a good performance roll. You roll a 3 there. You just got
literally.
Eye and turns back to the rest of the
rolls.
Okay. It's singular eye. I'm really just not that good with this loot.
I'm gonna. Oh, is it my turn? Even though initiative shouldn't.
Yes,
be this
it is
way.
Your turn.
Alright, I'm gonna be like. Did you do something to that girl that was kidnapped? Apparently
I
some
know
red.
That there are slaves kept in the pens, but I don't rather. I prefer not to go there myself. As I said, I stay in here.
Is it alright if we go in there, mate? A bit of a browse.
We'll leave your master alone if we can just let those prisoners out. Is that a deal?
And what would you offer from me in exchange for this compliance?
I say, well, there's a bunch
I'm
of...
I'm talking to you.
Okay. I shut up now.
What? Oh, omnipotent one. What do you wish from us?
I'm hardly under.
What would you want from us?
Wait. No, I just.
It's my turn. Talk on your turn.
Alright, he's not interested in me. I'm gonna go pee really quickly.
Alright, cool.
You guys have fun.
So what did you say, Pete?
Is there anything you want?
Okay. Yeah, that's fine.
The basics.
Sure, was he?
What does anyone want, really?
Hello.
Food, place to stay. I quite rather like this place, so I would prefer to keep it. But other than that, money is always.
So you don't have a USB
use for it. Whatever you have, really. Although, if you are the people who I suspect you to be,
you just got one?
Information is a very, very valuable commodity.
Actually, yeah, I just remembered. I've got a USB on my keychain for times like this. I'm like, I can really use a USB.
I got nothing.
I thought not. I could see it.
Oh.
I'm going to say, what do we take from that guy's office? A bunch of gold and stuff.
Oh, Charlotte, I didn't finish my list, but Charlotte.
Well, he just looted it.
It's a curious note.
So you looted the potion, right?
Yeah, we did.
I have it.
Okay, so if you haven't already marked it down, just mark it down as unusual potion.
Okay. What did I miss?
Nothing.
Literally nothing.
Okay,
the
cool.
The was talking and saying, like, offering up what it wanted. It already has, like, a place to stay. Food is preferred. Gold and other valuables.
I have some rations.
It would probably accept, but it has no use for them.
I mean, there are the four Red Brand prisoners if you want to munch on them.
It say that information was a very valuable commodity.
Information. I have some of that.
He's not talking to you.
I already said I didn't have any information, but I'm gonna go get those prisoners out, whether you want me to or not. So
go ahead.
Does he want some like information of like distant lands? Because I got some of that.
Okay, is it? I'm gonna ask.
I'm sure a story or two would be entertaining, but okay. Something more tangible would be preferred.
I'm gonna ask Frank where the prisoners are. I'm gonna start walking to where they are.
Okay. Oh, great, omnipotent.
Can you ping where Frank would? Because I've been trying to get that rule.
To the.
Where the prisoners would be held. You said like
the prisoners,
northeast.
The prisoners are in the northeast. Yes.
Okay. And we didn't see anything over here in the thing, so I guess.
Yeah, it was just an alcove.
All right. Well, I'm gonna start walking to this sort of area. To see if like it goes around back up or something.
Okay.
Okay, wait. I'm trying to engage in further conversation with the eye person thing.
He already admitted he's a distraction. What more do you want out of him? He's going to tell you anything you want to hear.
I feel compelled to. So, I address it.
Milo is essentially the eye monster. They both want the same thing.
To stall. Alright, I'm fine with that.
Okay, I address the monster.
I'm going with these guys.
Okay. So this hallway appears to be a threat. However, you notice that there appears to be a crack open on, like, on one side. It seems like this is actually what looks like a secret door.
Secret door.
Secret tunnel.
Secret tunnel.
You notice through the mountain. In this entry hallway, which is presumably where you would have entered if you had gone into the hideout from the other direction, you see more barrels of provisions and stuff on either side, flanking a sizable fountain, which is sort of fed by a spout in the shape of a lion's head. And you notice that on the ground next to the fountain appears to be an empty bag. Like a small leather pouch.
Take it, I guess.
It feels wet. It is definitely wet.
I jump.
See if there's anything unusual in the.
I jump in the fountain and start looking around.
You jump in the fountain. Pob, you may make that check. Beedie, you may also make that check. Perception.
Nat 20. I see all.
Oh, baby.
Woo! First nat 20 of the game, I think!
Man, are you still hanging out with this guy over here?
Yeah, I'm trying to address it and nobody's letting me address it.
Okay.
So, Single, from your position underwater, because you just jumped into this fountain, you can see that directly under the lion head fountain, where the water is like coming out, it's all like distorted because it's splashing into the water, so you wouldn't be able to see it very well from above water. However, below the surface, you can see very clearly that there is a sort of hook that could be used to attach something underneath the surface of the water, like maybe 3 inches down. However, there is nothing currently there.
It's a hook that would be used to attach. Can I roll insight on that?
You may.
What does it do, man?
So the pouch that you found off to the side of the fountain.
I take the pouch.
It has like drawstrings that seem long enough that it would certainly have fit underwater. And looking at it closer, it seems like it's designed in such a way to keep out as much water as it can.
Alright, I hang the pouch on the hook.
Nothing happens. The pouch is now underwater, sort of like drifting in the current and attached to the hook.
What's in the bag, man?
There's nothing in the pouch?
There's nothing in the pouch.
Wait, so... Does the hook look like it's on like a chain or like something that you would pull? Like a lever?
Yeah. It is attached to a stone surface.
Okay. All right. Nothing to see here, guys. I have no idea what this thing does.
I did want to see. Oh yeah, let's. I do want to let Ben talk to the guy if he's just staying over there. But also, after that, I did just check and see what's around in here. I don't know anything suspicious.
Yeah.
Nothing that you see.
Okay.
Alright, what's up? What's this thing up here?
I don't imagine that's seems the... like it's a door that
goes upstairs.
Alright.
No, it seems like it goes outside, actually.
Okay.
You also All right. notice that that door is open.
It's open?
It is open.
I say...
This was the secret door, which is why you found it.
The wizard might have gone this way, you guys. What do you think we should do?
I want to get the prisoners.
Yeah.
You guys,
if the brand leader is fleeing, then that should probably be good enough.
Frank, why don't you come with me and we can go after this guy? they can go get the prisoners. Split the party! Three ways!
I'm gonna go look for the prisoners, so...
Milo's just having a conversation. We're not too concerned about him.
Also, there appears to be a door here that leads under the sort of stairwell to somewhere further north.
Okay,
but what's this door over here?
Split the party four ways?
That door over there. You can hear what sounds like heavy breathing and a blade against wood.
Alright, we'll go north.
I say we go get the prisoners up here, man.
Is that where the prisoners are? Frank, you know where the prisoners are. Is that where they are?
Oh, hang on, boys. Watch this. Oh, Noah kicks the door down.
You kick the door down.
Yeah.
There are two guards, and one person who drops the sort of like wooden stick that he was like carving out with his short sword.
We just keep kicking doors down. Oh my god. Alright, initiative.
He sort of gets up and sort of rouses his buddies.
Eight still. Oh my god.
This is great. Just put him to sleep again, easy.
I don't have another sleep to use!
I thought you used all these two spells.
I did, I used one yesterday.
The door down.
Oh my god. Oh man. Oh man.
Oh jeez.
Zoinks, Scoob. Oh, Scoob.
Oh man, they both rolled higher. Also, which one is Frank? We need a different token for Frank.
However,
or at least a name.
Down the door.
I'm the one with the name tag.
You,
like a surprise round or something?
I don't see a name tag on yours.
Yes, you definitely get a surprise round.
Alrighty. With my surprise round.
He runs away.
Move back here.
Yeah.
Can I stand in this? Is this?
It's like waist high. It's deeper than the floor around it.
Yeah,
so
I'm not standing in it if it's waist high. Runs back here. He's like, all right, come on out, you blimey idiots. Enough of your shit. Come on, let's go.
Right.
That's pretty Aussie.
Pete, you're up.
I'm gonna step over here. I can see this one.
Don't
I'm going
stand in front of me. What are you doing?
I'm gonna move back after I'm done. I'm gonna cast Sacred Flame again. It's my only ranged thing I can do. So make a Dex save versus 13.
Which one?
On the guy that's directly in front of me.
Okay.
And then I'll roll for damage. It's a 1d8. Let me find the spell element first level instead of. Cast spell. That was really slow. 4 fire damage if they failed.
You sort of see the flames sort of whirl around him, and he definitely seems to have gotten hit.
All right, then I gotta move back, and that's my turn.
Okay. Single.
I'm really considering just yelling, traitors, get them, guys! But I'm not gonna do that. what do I have that I can do? I do have a crossbow. I also have spells I can use, but, I'm gonna cast a spell, actually. I'm gonna cast Vicious Mockery. Let me just pull that up.
Oh boy.
I'm gonna say, you're an idiot! You're dumb and you should feel bad! Your parents didn't really want you.
He sort of like looks to you, spits on the ground in front of him and says, my parents love me very much, thank you.
Damn it! You made the save.
Milo.
I don't think Ben would have heard any of this.
I've been trying to have a conversation with the eye monster for ages.
Oh, you have. You're so just back there. Okay.
Yeah, Ben's still back there.
Okay, so can I have...
Wait, I don't get the attack?
I can't have the conversation.
We will have that conversation right now. Okay, what are you doing?
Oh, great. Omnipotent. Telepathic.
Keep calling me omnipotent.
You said that like 8 times now.
I bow. Okay, what did he say?
You keep calling me omnipotent. I'm not. I've told you already.
But how could you talk in my head?
Oh my god. He
sort of like takes a claw, closes its eye, and just sort of...
He just face-palmed. You just got face-palmed.
I ask you of what information you seek for what we have requested.
My task is already done. I've already distracted you, and it seems like your allies could use your help.
That's not what I...
Even the monster is telling you to move on!
Not what I asked you. Oh,
it's just gonna sort of crawl down into the chasm, and you can hear this like chitinous sort of like tick 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 across the stone floor again.
Hey, Ben.
As it moves and sort of hides under this bridge.
Hey Ben, you would have gotten an attack of opportunity if you really wanted to do it.
I try and follow it.
Oh my god.
Roll me a dexterity save.
A dexterity saving throw.
Are you so you're jumping down the chasm? Just so you know, you're jumping down a chasm.
I could climb out of it, right?
Yeah, well, you're a halfling.
Easy to climb out of. It's just rough, somewhat steep. It's easy to do, but still requires a check. Yeah, you make it down there, no problem.
Do a fucking backflip or something.
Okay, I backflip off of it.
All right,
and I chase after him.
You chase after him. While you're doing that, I hate to be the one to do this, but I need to go to the restroom now, so...
Oh, okay. We can handle this on our own, right?
Sorry about that.
Sounds all good. Take some time, yell at Ben.
We can have a conversation.
I will be right back.
Alright.
Ben, what are you doing?
There's more to him than meets the eye.
We've got elevator music.
He's only got one eye. You can't, there's no more eyes.
Is that just a bad pun?
That was supposed to be.
He's literally got one eye and only had one job.
I feel like
he did very well.
Meets the eye.
You know, yeah,
and this is
really
a role-playing game, and I'm role-playing a character, and I can do whatever the hell I want as a character, okay?
I suppose.
I don't think we will be able to catch up to the boss man, so I figured, you know, get the prisoners out, and if the boss man...
Skip over
please,
that's what I figured.
Yeah,
no, we haven't had any turns yet.
I thought I rolled a higher initiative than Milo, though.
It seems like the initiative ordering's been weird.
Yeah.
Started, like, in the middle.
The DM is gone. Break rolls!
I think he started with you, Spivey, because you did the surprise round, and then he just did it from there, which messed it all up.
If I had my surprise round, he was still meant to stop in the top. But yeah. I rolled a 1, so it didn't really make a difference.
And then, I figure, you know, boss man's gone. The prisoners are always my priority. And, you know, if the boss man doesn't come back, great, right?
Sure. I mean, we were trying to capture him, but, you know.
Whatever, as long as the boss
man's gone. Why are we meant to capture the boss man?
Because, you know, there's, the lady in black said so. The Harper.
Oh. Okay. We'll
Alright, I'm back.
Okay, welcome back.
Action music.
Welcome back, Seth Bling here.
And you are not Seth Bling.
Back to the fight. Noah.
He already did his round, didn't he?
Oh no, it's my turn, I suppose. Can I, like, ready in action to, like, attack someone?
Wait, no. It cannot be Noah's turn. Because, Frank has not... Frank hasn't gone yet.
Oh, Frank, right. I forgot. Frank, you can go.
I want to throw a javelin.
No. Frank's got an initiative of 6.
But you had a surprise round and I skipped you because you looked like an enemy, so I'm sorry about that.
I just want to throw a javelin at the one at the bottom of the 3 there.
Okay. Make an attack roll. Alright. You sort of like throw the javelin, but being behind this staircase and two of your allies in front of you, you kind of get, it's hard to get a sort of good line. So you sort of throw it anyway, and it sort of like pings off of the side of the doorway.
Alright. I'm just gonna move in front of single.
Probably a good idea. Protect me, please. Single can use all the protection he can get.
This ruffian is going to now come outside of the door. And
I get an attack of opportunity when an enemy enters a 5-foot radius of
you.
I'm going to roll that. Gosh dang, Polar Master is so good. 10 damage.
Holy shit. So you sort of like whack him upside the head with the pole arm, and he sort of gets disoriented a bit, but he then makes a swing for Noah, which will miss, and he will take another swing at Yuki because you so ungracefully knocked him upside the head. That will also miss.
Oh. He's real dizzy from that hit.
He's a bit disoriented. He just got whacked pretty hard upside the head.
This ruffian will sort of like leap up onto the barrels and sort of stab at Noah from the barrels.
Seems like that might be acrobatics or athletics or dexterity or something.
However, balancing on these barrels, despite them being heavy enough to like carry his weight and stable enough to not really move so much, he does have a hard time like actually making the shots, the stabs connect, so he misses both his shots. Pete, you're up.
I'm gonna yell at the guy on the barrel. You don't look cool, even though you're trying to. And then I'm just gonna whack the guy in front of me. Do a little whack, and then do my second attack to try and, you know.
The second attack will hit.
Okay. Good. And that's really my turn.
He still appears to be up.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, this is a strong grunt.
Single.
I'm gonna yell at the guy on the barrel also and be like, you're not cool. You think that just because you can stand on a barrel, like, oh, look at me, I'm Mr. Fancy Man standing on a barrel. Dumb.
You did 1 second. If it lands.
If it doesn't make the saving throw. Does it make the saving throw?
You see very, very small tear just sort of
go down. Join the teamwork. He's failing.
He takes.
I request that you come over here so I can high five you really quickly.
I run over to Pete, high five him, and run back. That's my movement for the turn. Sorry if my yelling's too loud.
Can I share a square?
No.
No? Just blocking everything.
Jump on the fountain. I probably shouldn't have it. But
yeah, I guess I could do that. I'll hop in the fountain. And
no, it's like wasted.
Could you be standing on like the rim? The edge.
If you're standing on the rim, you have to roll acrobatics or something.
Sure, I'll roll an acrobatics check.
YOLO.
That might have been a bad idea. Okay, you know.
Awesome.
Do I maintain my balance or am I in the water?
You maintain your balance.
Alright. And then I'm going to take a swing with great axe at the guy right in front of me.
Okay.
Ooh. Frank was a barbarian this whole time.
So you sort of like
same your great axe
and just it sort of like cleaves into this guy's shoulder and just he's down.
He is no more.
The last ruffian that's just sort of in the room is just going to sort of hide in sort of cover, and he values his life. He's not gonna just throw it away.
Cool. I appreciate that.
He is sort of like hiding and preparing, or he's hiding. That's what you can see.
All right, Noah.
Okay. Oh yeah, it's my turn. Yeah, I'm gonna swing at the guy next to me. So, that's pretty much it. Nice elaborate turn. Alright, where's my rolls? Yeah. Yeah, no, don't worry about it.
Alright.
Cool. So, this guy is going to continue to sort of make stabs at you.
Yep.
And again,
he's at disadvantage.
Yeah, he has a disadvantage. Vicious mockery.
Viciously mocked.
He's so hurt. He's like, he doesn't think he's cool anymore standing on that barrel. How is he supposed to attack from that, you know? Like, what's the point?
He then sort of, like, looks around and you see that he isn't really feeling too confident about his abilities right now. Pete, you're up.
He just looks down sadly.
So, question, does this door open inwards or outwards? Like, do you...
It is currently kicked inwards off of its frame.
Okay. So that's a no-go. Alright, then I'll just do the standard. Can I just step on this guy's body?
Yeah.
Do my standard whack.
He's down pretty good.
Yeah, just a little whack.
So you sort of like whack him the second time. He sort of dodges and loses his balance enough for you to like hit him in the face the second on the backswing. And you sort of like knock the weapon out of his hand as well, and he just sort of like looks at you guys. He just sort of raises his hands. Single, you're up.
He's raised his hands. And the other guy.
You don't see this because he's around the corner.
Okay. I see. Look at this loser with his hands up. How far can I run? Let me see.
I mean, like, anywhere in the room.
Oh. I wanna check on this guy. I probably shouldn't. Yeah, I'm gonna, you know, I'm gonna move single up to the point where I can see that guy, and I'm gonna be like, good choice giving up. Hey, you in the room. Your friend's given up. The other one's dead. You only have one option here. What does he do? That's all I say.
You don't really see anything from around the corner. He's still just sort of hiding behind the wall.
Okay. That's my turn. I'm not doing anything else. I'm not about to run into battle or anything. I've learned my lesson a little bit.
You got plenty of...
I have some sense.
Tons of space to play around.
Frank, you're up.
Alright. Well, I'm gonna go visit him.
He's going to make an attack of opportunity as like a readied action as you enter the room.
Alright.
This will hit for not a it's not really that You don't really feel it much. It's just a scratch.
Yeah, you're already bruised and beaten up from earlier. Nothing really hurts you anymore.
Yeah.
It made you stronger.
Can I take my bonus action to rage and then I swing back?
You may.
I'm going to rage.
You are now raging. So he sort of hits you in the shoulder with his sword.
Oh, man.
You sort of roar at him, and he just sort of drops it and sort of scrambles and sort of topples over some barrels as he, like, is not by any means expecting this outburst of former colleague.
Oh, yeah, do you know this guy, Frank?
He used to work here, so he's probably seen these guys around.
I'm gonna kick the shit out of me, though, and I'm pissed off. Hit,
and getting sort of slammed in the chest also doesn't sort of improve the disposition of this guy. So you hit him pretty hard, and he's just sort of like prone in amongst a bunch of barrels at this point.
Yes.
Noah, you're up.
Spivey.
Oh, it's my turn.
Yeah.
Sorry, it just kind of comes around and I'm like. yeah, so I'll continue swinging this dude, dancing on a barrel.
He has his hands up. With no weapon.
What?
He dropped his weapon. Were you not paying attention to that?
I was paying attention when I heard the guy in the room did that, not this guy.
This guy also dropped his weapon.
Yeah.
Okay. Then, why are we in turn order?
I mean, if you want to still attack him.
I'm not going to attack him.
Okay. At this point, it seems like combat has defused a bit. There's still a lot of tension in the air, but no one is initially, like, killing anyone at this point.
There, okay, so,
although Frank is still in that room raging at this guy who is, like, in amongst a pile of barrels, so he might not be too...
Alright.
I'm gonna grab the guy's, weapon.
I'm gonna run in after Frank and be like, whoa, Frank, buddy, calm down. We don't need to hurt this guy.
He hit me first. Pissed me off, I hit him back.
I got you. Listen, guy.
Attack or be attacked again.
Yeah, guy on the ground. You don't want this guy to hurt you. I'm here to help you, okay? I just want you to tell me where the prisoners are, how we can get past them. And how we can get past your other guys, and where'd Glassstaff went? Real easy choice.
So
you know Frank. You don't want to make Frank mad.
From amongst the barrels, you see him just sort of like raise a thumbs up in the air, and sort of. The prisoners are usually kept up in the. Over in that part of the hideout, he sort of points to the north end of the room. I believe the most direct route would be through the door at the entranceway.
And Glassstaff, do you know where he went?
I don't know. He usually gives us orders. We don't tend to ask all that many questions.
Alright, well, how about this? Are you tired of taking orders from that Glassstaff asshole? That glasshole?
This just turned into an infomercial.
We don't want any trouble, okay? All we want is to help this town out. I'm sure you've just been doing this to get by. Come with us. We can take back this town.
I thought that was what we were already doing.
What? Ha! Listen, your little organization's not going to be around for much longer. You want to be on the good end of things, or do you want to Lay there and die like a fool.
So what, let me get this straight. What you're saying is I should abandon my boss, who's, let me tell you, a pretty scary fellow, and miss out on all of the opportunity for monetary in... I should be telling you this. Why the fuck am I telling you this?
Nah, mate, you're telling us wrong, man.
Roll intimidation.
Yeah, alright.
Oh wait, am I rolling intimidation or is Noah?
It's 5e.
Oh, no, well, okay.
Yeah, no, it's good.
Keeping an eye on this guy.
Advantage though, okay. Because we just beat the shit out of him, right?
Not advantage. I will tell you when you have advantage or disadvantage.
What about because Frank is being the bad cop here?
I will tell you when you have advantage. Nevertheless, he does sort of like stutter a bit and say, okay, sheesh.
Grab his weapons, I yell in the room.
Alright.
Sort of like drops his arms and sort of his head sort of rolls back a bit. You guys are new at this, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're not really in this for the whole beating people up thing and kidnapping. We just kind of wanted some peace.
Well, for people who don't do it for a living, you sure are damn bloody good at that. How that smarts, by the way. He sort of just... where the axe, like, has a very clean gash through his armor and the red cloak, and there's some blood there.
Yeah, we're just some travelers passing through, honestly. We don't even really know how we got here. What do you know about the spiders? Ah, fuck it, I don't actually care what you know.
Can
I kill him now?
I think, well, Frank, I don't know about that. Do you got any useful information for us, though? Anything that could help us, you know, destroy your entire organization or your way of life.
Well, what the fuck would you think I'd tell you for? I rather like the job I have.
Well, because Frank here wants to kill you, and I don't know that I can stop him. Or, I suppose I could, but only if you really want me to.
I'm gonna say this. Single, I think we might be running out of time. We should go get the prisoners and get out of heck.
Yeah, okay, yeah. I'll just slit this guy's throat real quick.
Whoa.
I start walking towards him.
Okay, whoa. Wait. What the fuck do you want to know?
We heard that you have information about some kidnapped dwarves. Do you know where Cragmar Castle? Do you know where that is?
Never heard of that in my life.
Okay, well then you're no use to us.
Insight check. Come on. You can't just let him.
I'm gonna run in the room and
right. Sort
of, I'm gonna drop my guard on this guy and run in and be like, We're not killing the guy. He doesn't have any useful information.
Inside check.
Let's get the prisoners and leave.
You don't think he's lying in the slightest?
I mean, I always believe everyone, so...
I go... I mean... We can't just leave him here alive. Right? I mean, not unless he agrees to...
I'd prefer that you do.
I have absolutely no problem knocking him unconscious with the sharp end of my axe.
The sharp end? I go, alright. I mean, Frank...
You just stay in this room, wait about an hour, and then we'll have gone on our way.
Like, it only takes me a minute to come out of rage. I don't even know if I'm out or not.
A small little powder keg, not actually a powder keg, but a small barrel about that size, and just sort of like... holding it as some sort of makeshift protection for against whatever the fuck you guys are about to do.
All right, listen. Listen, you either start telling us exactly, just like anything that you think we want to know, or we're just going to kill you. I'm sure you have some kind of information.
Yes, I do, but not fucking much. You have very high expectations. As I told you, we do have prisoners. They're in the... just north of here, in the holding cells. Glassstaff, you say he left or something. I don't fucking know where he's gone. But if he decides to come back here, which is a very big if, he would be in his office, which... it's in the...
We know where the office is. We don't care. All right, you've got nothing we really need.
Bloody idiots.
Oi, mate.
Yeah, no calling me a bloody idiot. I love my life.
If anyone makes an attempt to like attack him, I'm gonna stop them.
Okay.
Hey man.
You are seeing an action against your own party.
Yeah, absolutely. Hey, you two, man. Just wait in this room for like an hour. We're gonna go about our business. You get to keep your lives, and We'll get on out of here. No more trouble. Okay? Sound good? Sound like a deal? You guys clearly don't have any information. And I gotta poke Speedy and Frank.
I say I pull Pete aside and I go, listen, this guy clearly knows something he's not telling us. I'm sure of it, okay? Just listen, just hold up 1 minute.
Sounds
we can
good.
We can get something out of him, or at the very least get him to come with us as some kind of decoy.
Be like, whatever, man. We've been in this enemy hideabout for quite a while. It's your plan. I'm gonna just back out. Wait over here, just leaning on the wall.
I go. All right, Frank, you know what to do. And I walk away dramatically. Slowly.
Am I killing him?
I think so,
or
yeah.
Am I still just intimidating him?
I think you're gonna kill him, Frank.
Wait, no. I thought we had a deal. You let me go if I told you what I thought you wanted to know.
Well,
there's no reason to kill him, man!
Oh my god.
We're done here.
Yeah, Frank? So no one's gonna go up here.
Yeah.
Well, there's still this other guy too, right on the barrels?
Yeah, I'm gonna
yell
at him.
Yeah, he's just been like... He's now like sitting on a barrel. He doesn't have a weapon, he's just watching you all, all right. Sort of.
I'm gonna like tie him up or something. Can I do that?
Is there a check I can do to just knock this guy out cold?
He's gonna sort of like... attempt to clock you across the face for trying to restrain him.
He's on the ground, isn't he? Prone?
He's on a barrel.
The guy on the barrel would have clocked you if you tried to restrain
him. That guy.
I'm talking about clocking out the guy that's on the ground.
The guy on the ground is bleeding out and probably dead.
Oh!
No, not this guy.
No, the...
Oh, if this guy... Oh, I didn't realize that guy was dying. Could I...
No, this guy, the one that...
Yeah, that's what I mean. Could I...
Yeah, no.
Could I have, like, tried to... patch up his wounds really quickly?
You could have.
It's too late now.
But it's not late. Okay. I feel really bad.
Okay. I say, Pete, help me tie this guy up so he doesn't do anything.
I'm just gonna say he's fine in the room. It's his fault if he you know, his death wish if he wants to leave without arms.
No, but this guy right above us.
I know. Go in the room. I'm gonna yell at him. I'm gonna point to the, bedrooms.
He sort of like follows your orders and sort of flops down on one of the beds.
Alright.
I'm gonna
go over there.
And I'm gonna be like, alright, we'll post two guards here. And I'll like wink to everyone.
So,
in the least convincing way ever.
I am. Alright, yeah, we'll put the two strongest guys we have here just to. Make sure these guys don't put any trouble.
So, Noah, you enter a hallway.
And I put a barrel in front of the door, too, if I can.
A layer of, like, thick duck covers two strongest guys. This place. It doesn't actually seem like many people have walked through here recently, at least. There are sort of, like, faux columns every 10 feet or so. You can sort of see them lining the hallway. And there's a very ornate set of double doors at the end. The tiling in the floor appears to be sort of loose, and you can sort of pick, if you try, you can pick up some of them and just find dirt underneath. Frank. Alright.
Can I just see if I can maybe save this guy on the floor?
Can we take this room one step at a time, please?
Yeah, please.
Frank. And, single.
Look at it. I'm just
gonna... Okay, yeah, we're back here.
So, can we do a perception check for, like, any traps or anything?
You may roll perception.
Noah has played this game before, and he saw a long, empty hallway.
Alright, I'm just gonna sit out here behind the door waiting.
Where
actually,
this is...
I'm gonna go looking for Ben.
Pablo, you rolled a nat 1 on medicine check.
Yeah, that guy.
You tried amputating him. It didn't help.
Okay.
Now he's dead and missing it, all his limbs.
So, as far as you can see, Noah, as far as you can see, the hallway does not appear to be trapped.
Alright, so boys, I don't reckon there's anything in here, but, you know, just be careful going through away.
Okay. I tiptoe forward.
Like, he's taking his caution across the wall, like he's leaning against the wall, you know? And he makes his way across to the door.
I follow his lead.
Okay, so, no, as you step across, actually,
Oh, no.
Surprise! There was a trap.
Yeah. Bum, bum, bum.
That guy didn't tell us shit. He could have told us there was a trap and he didn't. What an asshole. We were gonna kill him.
Oh, what? No.
That's not right.
I thought he was bleeding out anyway, so I'm not too worried about it.
No, that's not. That's a different guy who was bleeding out.
Yeah.
I thought he was bleeding out.
Nah.
Okay.
Just injured.
So,
deck save or anything?
Deck save, yes.
Hell yeah.
Real quick.
My favorite stat.
Or I'll just message this to you, Steve.
Mm-hmm.
That's not good.
No.
No, that's not a very good deck save.
Yeah. So
one would say it wasn't a save.
You fall 20 feet down as, like, the stone tiles sort of give way underneath. You hear the breaking of wood as you struggle to catch the ledge and fail. And you fall directly down 20 feet, landing prone and taking a total of 2d6 damage. Let me just do that for you.
That doesn't sound good.
I mean, even if he rolls max, he's not down.
I mean, that's, like, good, I guess.
Total of 6 damage. Bludgeoning.
Oh, boy.
Noah, you all right down there?
Yeah, mate. Yeah.
Is it the hole deep enough, or, like, shallow enough that you can get out? Or that we could jump across?
It's 20 feet.
It's 20 feet across, too?
No,
it's 20 feet down, but it's 10 feet across.
Okay. Is there a noticeable way across? Can I look around for anything to, like... Well, actually... I look around for any way for him to get out. Anything to deactivate the trap or something. They must have a way of getting these people out, right?
Activated.
Heads up, I'm just gonna use Second Wind. Just so you know.
Yeah, okay.
It seems like the trap was just the one time and it's broken. You do notice that there are small ledges along the north and south of the corridors where the trap is probably mounted, where there's still probably a bit of solid footing, but it's a very narrow path.
Okay.
So it's potentially climbable?
It's smooth stone.
Okay.
So is that how we would get around?
Potentially.
Okay. I say, Frank, you want to try this?
I'll give it a shot.
Checking. Frank, maybe it'd be better if you just threw me.
I could also do that.
Nah. Let's just go. I try and edge along the edge or whatever.
That's a wall.
Yeah, you know. You said there was some...
I need you to make a dexterity check. Acrobatics.
Acrobatics. 21. Alright, and I toss Noah down a rope. Well, I guess I'll wait for Frank.
Also, where's Pete?
I'm gonna wait out here.
So, oh, wait, actually...
Alright, if you motion for me, I come back in.
Yeah, I'm calling to you.
Sure.
I'm also gonna need you to make an acrobatic check.
I don't have any rope, so.
I can climb up, alright.
Okay. I'll make an acrobatics check.
Oh.
So, you sort of make your way around the edge like you've seen your partners do, but you sort of get like the wrong footing and sort of slip and fall into the pit and. You take 4 bludgeoning damage.
That's not that bad.
No, it's not.
Thank goodness.
Do you want me to roll something to get out, or...?
Can I have some... both of those people are already across, right?
Yeah.
Alright, I'll just be like, hey, just pick me up and get out of here.
So, the people holding the rope, I'm gonna need you to roll strength checks.
I'm not holding a rope.
Was it Pete that fell in, or was it me that fell in?
Both.
Wait, Sandwich fell in?
But he rolled a 17.
Sandwich rolled a 17!
Yeah, no. Frank is across. It's Noah and Frank in the hole.
Okay.
Or just give me a little bit of loose. Boost.
Oh, okay.
You know?
Hey, Pete, you got a rope? Throw it up here, and we'll...
I used the rope to tie it down the cards earlier.
Oh. Hey, Frank, you got a rope?
No. I'm basically empty.
No, you do have a rope. You have, like, 50 feet of rope strapped to, like, a backpack of yours.
No.
It's the Explorer pack.
Basically everyone gets a 50-foot rope.
Okay, then I'll throw down my rope.
Yeah, I guess I'll,
You're tied to something, man!
Yeah, is there anything we hear we can tie it to?
There are doorknobs on the door, but they don't really seem that stable.
Okay, yeah, let's just pull him up.
Okay, strength checks from the people holding the rope.
Oh, that's gonna be good for me.
I mean...
Not saving throws, checks.
Oh.
Unskilled strength check. 11.
Well, this is not that
that's,
big.
Yeah, it's no.
Where...
Oh, wait, actually, hold on. I have, I forgot to... I have Jack of All Trades that I forgot to enable, so add a plus one to that.
With both of you sort of pulling on the rope, you're able to get one of them across, and I presume that person can then help get the last one across, so
yeah.
You guys are fine.
Okay.
Ben is still just sort of chilling in this pit with the Nothic. They're having a grand old time.
Oh, yeah. What's Milo up to?
Very, very much getting, like, annoyed with Milo's... continued presence and has told him numerous times to leave, but for some reason Milo is still there.
Ben, are you gonna come back and come over here, or you gonna keep bothering the eyeball?
What are you doing?
I continue. What am I doing?
What are you doing?
Are you gonna keep following that guy?
that if he wants me to be less ignorant, then make me less ignorant with his secrets and experiences. That's what I told him.
He's currently ignoring you, and he, like, shoots you this very, very angry glare with this one green eye. And it seems he really, really doesn't want you to stick around any longer.
I take a deep breath. Then your knowledge dies with you. And then I leave. Wait, does he respond to that?
He just sort of, like, chuckles a bit.
That could have been considered a threat. I wouldn't have worded it.
Well, did he take it as a threat? Or did he know what I intended?
I mean, you're walking away, so...
The wording was a bit off, and he was confused a bit, but he, as you're turning away, he sort of realizes, and that's when you hear the chuckle. So, I assume okay. You join the people over...
I heard nothing but a chuckle there. Okay, so, do I have to roll a dexterity check?
No, you're fine. You make your way to the hallway. The people help you across.
I'm growing impatient. I'm just walking in.
Oh, whoa!
Nope.
It's okay. Might be style. He is growing impatient. Down. He is just walking in. It appears to be a crypt of sorts.
Lovely.
There are three coffins here, all covered with dust, although some less so. And
I'm gonna check for traps. As is the trap here.
Propped up against each sarcophagus, appears to be a sort of like human skeleton, each in on its own shackle against the wall. And they're sort of clad in bits of rusty mail. Similar to the hallway, false columns are like lining this room, one in each of the sides. And the walls are carved in an image of like oak trees just sort of spreading up and around. It's a very nice little marble or stone relief.
I'm also gonna check for traps. I'm with Pablo on this one.
As far as you can tell, there are no traps.
Oh man.
That's a pretty good roll.
Alright. Speedy says that. So I'm just gonna walk on across.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna start looking at these coffins.
I'm gonna open the door. Ignore the crypts. We're going for the
What do I notice about the coffins?
So the coffins themselves are closed, and on top of them, like, sort of resting against them, almost sitting on them, and sort of chained to the wall, appear to be, like, skeletons, one on each coffin. They are wearing, like, bits of, like, rusted armor, like, leather armor that's sort of decaying, but they appear to be motionless.
Are all of them, do they all look similar to each other, or are they all unique?
They're all skeletons, so as far as skeletons go, they're pretty similar.
Is there the same amount of dust on everything?
I'm gonna see if they're magically enchanted.
Okay.
Considering I have a -1 on this, 17's pretty good for me.
From what you know...
Damn.
From what you know of magic, it is entirely possible that skeletons may or may not be animated. However, you do not know, nor did you just cast the Detect Magic spell. So you do not know.
Well, you know...
Alright. I attempt to open the coffin right next to me.
Oh, man.
You open the coffin next to you.
I rolled a strength check just in case.
Alright, continue on to the next room.
The coffins are locked tight, you guys.
Focus. Open the door.
Wait, there are two doors.
No, it doesn't matter. Door. Full left wall, left wall.
Are we in a labyrinth?
Oh.
Alright, this door.
I say this door
first
now.
Check it.
Since that's a
check
long hallway. First. Long hallway is always in
there. So that door appears locked.
Okay, well, this door. So you pull it left wall.
Frank's opening this door. Alright,
yeah.
Open it.
Okay. I'm opening
it. Just going for it.
So you open the door, and you sort of see two ruffians just sort of, like, leaning against the walls, sort of tossing what appears to be a ball, like, bouncing it on the floor back and forth to each other. One of them sort of looks up at you. Noah, are you wearing a red cloak?
Yes.
Yeah, he is.
All right. Sort of look at you, nod their head a bit, and continue doing what they're doing. They do notice the bunch of the guys past you, and they don't really seem to mind at this point, that you know of.
All right, Frank is still, like, a prisoner, right? He looks like a prisoner. He's still beat up.
Mm-hmm. He's not tied anymore.
I say, got a new prisoner. As we walk Frank in.
Which cell do you want?
North one, I suppose.
Okay. This guy just sort of, like, stands up and unlocks the cage, opens the door. The woman inside the cage is just sort of scurries back to the corner away from the side that was opened.
Okay.
While that's going on, I also ask to retrieve one of the prisoners from the south cage.
What for?
Oh, you know, the boss needs it.
Roll persuasion.
I don't know what for in particular. They don't tell me this sort of shit, you know.
Roll either persuasion or deception.
Both are not very good. So
do a little roll.
He just sort of looks at you, squints a bit. If the boss says so, he opens this door as well.
Alright. I turn around, wink at the other guys, right? And then roll initiative, right?
Yeah, I cast Friends on the South Guard.
Wait, why?
Okay.
And as I'm walking past this North Guard, or after he's unlocked the cage, I suppose.
Both cages are unlocked at this point.
Yeah, I pull out my, my stiletto, my pink stiletto, and I hold it to his throat.
The north guy?
Yeah, the north guy. I'm not actually attacking. I don't know if I need to roll for it. I'm holding it to his throat.
Like, that would be an intimidation.
Okay.
How long does Friends last, by the way?
A minute.
Okay. The North Guard is not particularly intimidated by you and says, "What the hell are you planning?" He sort of, like, swats your hand out of the way and goes for his sword. At this point, I assume you're, like, at this point in the room or over here?
I'm like, right here.
Okay.
When did Penn get here? Hey, Milo, man.
Now we roll initiative.
I say to the South Guard, he's a traitor! The boss told us to take him in!
Roll persuasion.
With advantage.
Actually, roll deception. One of the two.
17.
Natural one. Oh, wait, with advantage?
With advantage. Friends.
He just kind of looks at you, looks across at the guy. You see that he's not entirely sure what to think. But both of these guys are not expecting this sudden, like, ambush. So, but you do not have a round of surprise, unfortunately, but roll initiative.
All right, I guess.
Nat 20 on initiative, woo!
Frank got a nat 1.
I didn't do so hot.
I didn't do so hot either!
Man.
Oh, wait. So, still initiative?
If I can push my way into the room, I will. And, I'm going first. Ben is roboting.
Ben, your voice is,
Alright, Pete, you're up.
So I was back here. Could I push my way into the room here?
Yeah, you can do that.
Okay. I was gonna whack the guy up top twice. You know, nothing fancy.
Okay.
Do a little of this. Do down and I did 9 points of damage, and I'm gonna be like, prison break, man!
Why are you saying, oh, Ben, your camera went away. Oh, God damn it.
How did it go away?
It's back.
At this point, it's a little obvious.
Okay.
Thank you.
I'm not gonna yell at folks.
You know. Did you actually yell at?
Well, I'm telling you, the prisoners.
Okay.
So this guy is even more confused now. Because there's the guy who just attacked his friend and called him a traitor. And then the guy who attacked his friend who just yelled, prison break. No idea what to think.
Oh, God.
I love to ruin things.
That's like, that's my MO, is to ruin things. Okay, well, what now? It's Milo's turn.
Okay, it's my turn. Okay. Is everything robot-y still?
No, you're fine.
No, you're fine.
You're better. Okay.
So, move into the room. Okay, what is the current state of, what is that? What did I do? Okay, go away. Okay, what's the current state of play at the moment? Because I missed it because it was all robot-y.
So, looking into the room, there are a bunch of your allies just sort of crammed in the doorway, so you can't really see much, but you do hear a lot of commotion from within the room. Single just shouted traitor, at which point you hear a voice you don't recognize say, what the hell? And immediately afterward, Pete is just saying, prison break! So that's all you really know.
Okay, so does anybody actually see me? At this current moment, does anybody
pay
attention to me?
I feel like they're more focused on the people in the room.
Okay, so
you
I'm going
get sneak
to do...
attack.
What do I do to... I don't know if I should do a sneak attack or I should...
No, you automatically get sneak attack once you make an attack.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna
they're
roll.
They're being flanked right now.
Okay, so I'm going to put... I'm going to go... and see if I can persuade or not now, since that is my obvious special ability.
Wait, what?
What would it be, deception? I'm gonna go with the owlbear.
You're pretending to be an owlbear.
Okay, again.
Oh, come on. Yeah. Nat 20. Give me... I want a nat 20.
Okay, so what should I do? Deception.
Roll deception.
You have no magic to convince anyone you're an owlbear. And
wait
yet...
till you're level 3 to start convincing everyone you're an owlbear. You get illusion magic.
Wait till you dual class with druid or something.
What does that do?
So, you sort of roar, and the two people, they probably heard it, but they're already focused more on the three people, like, immediately in front of them who are, like, just breaking out into combat suddenly. So they don't really pay you much attention.
Dang it. Okay, so can I
still
sneak attack?
No, doing the deception would have been your action.
Okay, so I stay. I just stay. Wait,
okay.
Actually, wait, I'm just gonna move in front of the sarcophagus.
Alright.
Okay.
I'll just stand on top of it.
Okay.
Are you wearing a red cloak?
No, I was the spider.
He is not, yeah.
You're the spider. Okay. Good to know.
He's a spider and an owlbear. Okay. Noah?
Yep. I'm going to swing.
At which guy?
That's pretty much it. The guy in the north.
Okay.
The guy in the north is going to get an opportunity attack against you for... Actually, no, he doesn't,
because
you're still...
No, because I don't leave his threat range.
Yeah, you're still within threat range, haha.
Got him. Alright, I'm rolling.
But,
Oh, wow.
Alright.
13 points.
What?
Well then.
What? He's hurt.
I did it.
He's hurt.
This guy doesn't know what to think. He just sees... He just saw you yell traitor, and then just fucking all gang up on his buddy. The guy he thought he knew. He's just gonna, like, go down to his knees and have a minor mental breakdown for this turn. Like, he
is like, what? I think it would have been really funny if Milo had busted in pretending to be an owlbear and succeeded. Like, one guy says he's a traitor, another guy shouts prison break, and then there's an owlbear in the room.
Still having his mental
breakdown. Oh my god. It's my turn, though. So that guy's down, right? Mm-hmm. I'm gonna go, alright, we got him. Now, I'm gonna need you to come with me. And I just grab him by the collar. And I go, don't worry, you're not in trouble. The boss just needs to talk to you.
Roll persuasion.
18!
Natural 20, because you have the friends.
Oh yeah, woo! Nat 20!
He just sort of like complies and sort of lets you like lead him around.
All right.
Frank, what are you doing?
Well, isn't combat over now?
I'm just going to get out of the way of the door.
All right.
There's not much left for me to do.
I say, Pete, get that prisoner out of the north cell.
Sure thing, man. But real quick, I'm going to turn to the guy who's all crazy and, you know, they'll be like, hey, man, what's in the room over, and I'm going to describe this area.
That's the armory. That's where we keep all the extra weapons.
I knew that, man. I'm gonna go up to this and be like, hey, you in the cell, you're coming with us. I'm gonna wink at them, yeah, not very subtly at all.
Same thing with the bottom prisoners as well.
They all sort of like cautiously approach.
All right, and I take this guy by the collar. Do the prisoners leave the room yet?
Not yet. They haven't. Milo, you're up. What are you doing?
Okay. I'm just gonna walk into the room. I'm just gonna strut. I'm gonna walk up to him, and I'm going to try and convince him he's going madly insane.
What?
I'm just gonna do it.
Okay.
Wouldn't that be deceptive?
How are you going to convince him that he's going insane? That's the real question.
The moment you say convince.
Okay, I'm going to try and deceive him into thinking that...
This would be...
What are you going to say?
I'm trying to think of a way to sort of make him go insane. Like, what's his current state of mind now? I just want to know so I can get, like, a...
He's just, like, following Singles' orders and, like...
Yeah, I've got him by the collar. He's listening to me.
Because the boss has requested his presence.
Yeah.
Okay, so that wouldn't be advisable. I thought he was still in the middle of his mental breakdown.
No.
He was, and then Single gave him some sort of direction.
Yeah, he's still pretty flustered, but he's
May I suggest looting the dead body? Because you're right next to it, anyways.
Yeah, I'm just looting it.
See if you can get an armory key.
Yeah.
Good.
Frank.
Perception. Huh?
Frank, I'm gonna need you to roll perception for me.
Okay.
Oh.
8.
Okay. So, as you are focused on your... As you're focused on your allies and their actions in the other room...
I just remembered something. I know what's going on.
I think so too. We kind of just left some barrels guarding some guys. That might have something to do with it.
You notice one of the skeletons have broken from their shackles.
Oh, okay.
I forgot about the skeleton guards that I knew about, but I didn't say anything about. Nobody asked. Where the prisoners were.
Also, you realize this is a very inopportune time for you to not be wearing your red cloak.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
I have that on, eh?
No, it's one of the three that you gave to the other people.
Yeah.
You should probably have that on.
Whoops.
Nevertheless, you knew about this and were prepared for it, so the skeleton just sort of, like, stabs at you and the shot goes wide. Noah, you're up.
Man, alrighty. I just...
You hear Frank yell from the other room.
Wait, one second, real quick. I have a spell that, like, basically, like, destroys undead. Like, not really, but, like... And I wasted it trying to charm a rat. Sorry, wasn't expecting undead in here.
Nobody asked?
Okay. Alright, so Noah runs into the other room like, whoa, what the blimey heck is this?
And you see just... the three skeletons sort of risen
hey,
from...
Hey, he's wearing a red cape. Did they deactivate?
They sort of look over at Noah, and then all focus back on Frank.
Alright, well, I'm going to charge over to this one and take a swing at it. Is that alright? I can do that?
Yeah, you can do that.
I'm doing it.
No, I'm you not miss.
Doing it. Okay. I don't know, it's a skeleton with decrepit armor. You might. No.
Man, I was like, why hasn't combat ended yet?
That guy's dead. The skeleton sort of... It missed the swing, so it's gonna go over here. It seems to be ignoring you, Noah, and it's going to sort of swing at Frank and miss as poorly, if not more so, than its comrade. This guy is just gonna, like, enter the room and be like, what's all this about?
Wait, whoa, I still have him by the collar.
You do have him by the collar. He is not doing
He's anything. Not going anywhere!
He's not going anywhere unless you make him go somewhere.
Yeah.
The third skeleton is going to stay where it is and shoot, like, an arrow at Frank. And while these skeletons are fucking terrible.
Want to borrow these?
No bones about it. Okay, it's my turn.
I'm gonna start rolling physical dice. Roll 20 sucks this bad.
I mean, we've all been rolling pretty poorly.
I'm okay with my attack rolls so far.
Yeah.
It's been like
supposedly
3 or 4 weeks.
Either way. Single.
All right. I go, hold on 1 second. Come with me. I throw... whatever's going on there, we gotta stop real quick. Get in the cell. I throw him in the cell, and I take out the prisoner.
I'm gonna need you to roll persuasion again on that.
I'll assist in pushing him in there. If I can. Or, well, never mind, actually. That'd be
14.
Next action.
He
doesn't really seem comfortable going inside the pen, because usually the boss doesn't want to be seen near the prisoners. So he's going to try and resist. Pablo and Single, I'm going to need you both to roll athletics. Check.
Athletics.
Lovely.
Oh, man. That is a zero bonus for me.
That was zero All bonus right. as well. Oh, 19.
So Pablo is able to sort of, like, shove this guy in.
All right.
This one just sort of, like, runs out and sort of runs over to... these people and sort of like,
I say, oh shit, he probably has the key, but I slam the door behind him anyways.
You slam the door behind him. It does not lock, but it's closed.
Alright, I also search the body of the guy right in front of me for a key.
You find a key.
He was just holding it out.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
You find the key, fortunately, to the top cell.
Yeah, okay, I lock that.
You lock it. This guy's gonna, like, approach the bars and be like, hey, what's the meaning of this?
You'll be out in a minute. We just have to deal with this real quick.
Fine. Make it quick. He just sort of settles in to, like, sit.
Cool.
Back wall.
And then I go out here and I peek my head out and see what's going on. Or I stay inside the room, but I look at what's going on there.
You've already done enough for your action. Frank, you're up.
I'm swinging at the one that's right next to me.
Which one?
The one south of me, still in the sarcophagus.
Alright, cool. That'll hit.
14.
Oh, man.
I'm not raging anymore. so it's just 14.
That's still a lot.
You just sort of like take your great axe and just sort of like lift it over your head and just sort of slam it down, directly bisecting the skeleton fucking vertically.
And damn sort of bag of bones.
A pile of bones, like, on either side, just spilling over the coffin.
Yes! I'm okay with the result.
I'm gonna take the cloak off of this guy, and I'm gonna go over the these people and say, oh, we're here to help! And I'm gonna hand them the cloak, and one of them the cloak, and be like, we don't have extra cloaks, but we're gonna... You might be able to use this to at least,
it's
you
sort
know,
of like,
check some people.
So... This woman appears to be older than these two. They're all female, by the way. They're all female prisoners for one.
Oh, that's kind of disturbing. So what do they look like, by the way?
She sort of takes the cape from you and says, thank you. Thank you very much.
Stay with us and you'll be safe.
Wraps it around her and sort of hulls next to the two prisoners.
At this point, I'm gonna stand by the door waiting to see if something comes through, but I'm not gonna. That'll end my turn, probably.
Okay. Milo!
Okay. I only have a rapier, I have a dagger, I'm gonna go and walk. I'm going to do that, and I'm going to hit it. Okay, so what's with my sneak attacks again? I'm trying to remember.
Since he's being flanked with Spivey on the side.
Mm-hmm. It's automatically rolled, don't worry about it.
You don't have to worry about it, just roll damage.
What you gonna do, Milo? What are you attacking with?
Try to decide between the rapier and...
Just choose
if you
one.
Use the if you use the dagger, you can use your bonus action to a second attack, but if that doesn't get sneak attack damage.
Rapier, then.
Yeah.
Wait, no. So, yeah.
But the second one isn't guaranteed to hit.
That.
Yeah.
Alright.
13 damage.
Okay.
Pretty sure he hits.
That is indeed 13 damage. And you just sort of, like, stab it upwards, like, and the skull just sort of, like, gets impaled on the end and sort of lifts away from the rest of the body. You see it sort of, like, trying to bite as the rest of the skeleton just, like, falls to the ground limpless. Limping, like, lifeless yet again.
Lifeless, more than usual.
Yeah.
It was undead, now it's re-dead. Yeah.
Yes. Those are still terrifying. Legend of Zelda, anyone?
No.
Anyway.
I didn't get it until you mentioned it.
Still terrifying.
Yeah. Because that one was destroyed, I'm gonna go over the next one further up. And swing at that one and probably miss. I'm really excited.
So excited to probably miss.
13.
Well, for good news is you didn't miss.
Wow.
Bad news is you didn't kill it.
That's fine. I hit it.
That's the most you can hope for, right?
Yeah.
It's gonna drop its bow and take out a sword like the others, just for that was lying on top of the coffin, and it's gonna swing at you. This will hit, albeit for not much damage. And that's its turn. Single, you're up.
Alright, I'm gonna search this guy's body some more for a key to the armory, possibly, or anything else he might have on him.
Alright, you do not find a key to the armory, however, you do find a sort of... He has a pouch on him containing, like, two more gemstones. Not nearly as good quality as the ones you found in Glassstaff's room, but still probably valuable nonetheless. Two peridotes, I believe.
Okay.
Two additional peridotes.
And that was all?
That's it.
Okay, and also, do you have a weapon on him?
Yes.
All right. I take that weapon and I say
amassing short swords.
No. I grab it. I say to the women who are like imprisoned, any of you know how to fight?
They all sort of stare back at you, and after a few moments of silence, they just sort of shake their head no.
All right, well...
Swing this at the bad guys.
This... First lesson, pointy end at the bad guys, and I throw it to the one closest to me.
I'm going to need you to make a acrobatics check.
Oh man, I hope I didn't just stab anyone.
Also the floor.
It's 18.
Oh my god.
Oh boy.
Alright, so it wasn't really expecting that, but she manages to sort of like dodge out of the way. The sword sort of clatters to the ground behind her, and she sort of goes to pick it up, and she's uneasy holding it, but she thinks she can handle it.
I say, alright, well, I say, okay, now wait here one more second while we clear this out, and then, we'll help you.
Okay. She sort of, like, breathes out a sigh of relief as she realizes you're not asking her to fight immediately.
Yeah.
Smashy time.
Frank smash! Frank misses!
Frank smashy. Pete.
Alright, Pete's gonna pick up the slack here. And, what are you lot doing, you know? What are you fools doing? Move over here, do a little wacky-wacky. Do a little this, and do a little that. Nat 20, and 22.
Yeah. You that have hits. A habit of, like, hitting things more than once when one shot will do them.
Well, I just click both buttons. Fair enough. Gonna do it. Like, I don't see the rolls until after I...
Yeah, no problem.
You crit.
So...
I thought you guys were the fighters. I'm the healer. What do you can't take down a little skeleton.
You're both.
what are you doing?
So, The crypt falls silent again as the skeletons return to piles of bones on top of or near the crypts they once were resting at.
Okay. I'm gonna say to the garden there, hey, you have the key to the armory, right? Give it to me.
He just shakes his head no. Only Glassstaff does. He loans the weapons out to those who don't have their own.
Fair enough.
Oh, okay. Alright, well, I'm gonna need you to wait right there for another, I don't know, 30 minutes? We've got some issues going on outside.
Jesus fucking Christ, just deal with it already.
Okay, and I take these women, I say, come with me. And,
they follow.
Is one of these women, like, a halfling girl, by the way?
Yes. You notice there's the one who was in the upper cage who seems to be an adult, and then the two who were in the lower cell appear to be smaller. One of them is actually a child, and the other is a halfling.
Okay.
Child.
Save the chit chat for later, man. I think we really ought to get out of here.
Hold on. I say before we go, we try and kick down that armory door. Anyone? I mean, I'm not gonna do it, because I'm just a rock gnome, but, you know, if you guys want to.
I will assist, which gives him advantage on the thing, if that's gonna be a thing. But,
You may assist in trying to break down the door. Roll
wait, before I do that, let me check for traps.
I mean, I already walked down the hallway in bed.
Okay, fine, you...
I rolled.
Yeah,
that was...
Well,
that's a saving throw.
Oh. Right. Unskilled strength.
Athletics.
Oh, you want athletics?
Yeah. All the best athletes kick down doors. Alright. Moving on.
No go, man. Let's get out of here.
I say to the halfling girl, Don't worry, your mother sent us. We're here to help.
About bloody time.
What? And I say to the woman, why were you here? Who are you? The adult one.
Okay. So the adult woman sort of my name is Myrna. We were traveling and they came upon us and attacked so suddenly, and thank you for saving us. I'm not from a wealthy family, certainly not, but I think I might know, if you require a reward, I think I might know where such an heirloom was hidden.
Well, I mean, as much as that reward sounds lovely, the only reward that I could ever want is a kiss from one such as lovely as you.
Roll persuasion.
Unfortunately, he's not the only one here, so, yeah, where is it?
22!
Finally, could roll for you.
She seems disturbed.
What?
To say the least. Like,
a 22!
Yes.
That's not the same. That's not the sort of thing that you get asked, like, point blank. Every
yeah,
time.
But I was so smooth about it. Disturbed isn't the right word. Shocked. But intrigued.
Not quite. Anyway, moving on. So Noah sort of presses her for a more tangible reward, and she says, yeah, yes, yes. I used to live over in Thunder Tree, actually. But My family fled after it was overrun by the undead. We had an alchemy shop full of herbs and medicines, and there was a necklace, one of my mother's. It had a beautiful emerald in it, and it was hidden beneath some shelves that we used to store some of the medicinal poultices on. I never dared to return to retrieve it. Thunder Tree has become quite dangerous, as I've heard of it.
Thunder Tree. Do I know anything about Thunder Tree?
You know that Kaelin was from Thunder Tree, but...
I know that. I say, Thunder Tree, would you happen to know someone by the name of Kaelin Anastasia?
Kaelin. It was quite some time ago. Perhaps we may have run into each other, but I do not remember.
All right. Once we get out of this, I think she'd rather like to meet you. But let's focus at the task at hand.
I would love to reunite with more of the survivors who fled.
Let's chit-chat, man.
All right, let's
more
go.
More leave of Red Brand Hideout.
I'm sorry to trouble you. The necklace is quite... It's valuable, and it's all that I have to offer, and I can't even do that. It's
perfectly all right.
It would be fantastic to go to retrieve it. I wouldn't wish that upon you if you didn't truly want to go to those lengths yourself.
It's perfectly all right. You've suffered enough.
Thank you.
All right.
Let's make an exit.
Yeah, how do we, Wait. I go up here, and I like, knock on this other wall right here.
You knock on the other wall. It appears thin, almost as if it, too, is a secret door. I'm going to need you to roll Perception with advantage.
Oh, I rolled Persuasion. Whoops.
Hello,
Perception.
Indeed...
Please. The magic word is please. Yes.
similar to down below, these appear to be secret doors.
Okay. I open the secret door.
It leads where you would expect.
Yeah, okay. I say, let's go this way, guys. There's a secret door. It leads back.
But the exit's right over here.
Do you want to have to try and jump over that pit again?
I suppose that makes sense.
All right, let's go this way.
So as you're sort of going through, you notice the Nothic is just sort of like chilling on the side of the embankment under the bridge and just sort of not really paying you much attention, but it does notice your presence.
I toss him a piece of rotten meat.
It looks not like meat.
Animal handling?
It looks at the meat. It looks at you. It does so again. I need you to make a constitution save.
Oh man, oh no. I don't want to do this. 11?
It stares at you with this very foul, evil intent, and you feel like your soul just sort of like it feels very strange. You almost feel cold as you just almost as if your own skin is rotting, and you are now unconscious.
Oh my god! Okay, well.
None of you heard anything beyond, hey guys, I think there's a secret door that leads back to the entrance.
Well, no, I said come back this way, you don't want to jump over that thing again.
Yeah,
so,
enough.
They're coming, right?
What happened? I completely missed out. So
that's fine. You're not supposed to know.
Yeah.
Walk over, so please. Everyone.
The pit again.
Roll a death save.
I'm sitting there going, I have a decent dex score. Maybe I should try the pit.
Speedy, roll a death save.
Oh, okay.
It's I will make my way downtown.
Walking fast.
Made it.
That is one success. So you all notice Single just sort of like unconscious on the floor.
We all don't notice him?
And like,
you do notice.
You notice Single unconscious on the floor, and a piece of like rotting meat just sort of between him and the edge of the embankment. Sort of like looking up over the edge is the Nothic, who just sort of like chuckles and just goes back to chilling underneath the bridge.
Alright, I would have made my way over here by now.
Yeah.
You wanna
take a second death save, and then it doesn't really matter because you will have heals.
I'm gonna be like, oh no! Single's down! We should prioritize getting the hostages!
We should.
I'm gonna cast my last spell, Cure Wounds. I'm in my cantrips, you know, just take a little heal, buddy.
Four.
The minimum.
Minimum
roll,
healing.
Four.
All right. I'm up.
I'm gonna put together what happened, and I'm gonna apologize to the Nothic. The only thing I can think is, since the Nothic hasn't attacked us so far, is that Speedy must have just annoyed him.
Oh, you got that right.
Okay.
I'm sorry he's in.
I don't know what just happened there, guys. Let's go.
You feel more strongly than usual that you just came back from the brink of death.
Alright. I start walking out. You want to just leave? Let's take the hostage and get out of here, you guys. Can we just do that?
Try follow the wizard.
Yeah, you can go. The Nothic doesn't really bother you at all.
Okay.
Let's go. let's go this way.
Okay, as I
leave the mansion.
Right. And do some cheeky looting on the way out.
Ben the robot.
Huh? Oh.
Never mind, you're no longer a robot.
Okay, as I walk by the Gnostic, I whisper, I want your knowledge. And then
oh my god.
I want you gone.
What are we gonna do with the ladies?
They're coming out.
I mean, okay. since single rescued them, I'd have to say they're the single ladies.
Yeah, the single ladies. Come along, girls.
No, they're not.
They're single ladies.
Is that girl married? Is that why she didn't want to kiss me?
It was just a weird thing to ask, Speedy.
You feel like she would be married.
You feel like she would be married.
I mean,
all right.
Roll insight.
I'm just walking along. I passed out, and I just can't stop thinking about it. 19.
So, when she sort of ran from one cell to the other, she wasn't so much comforting the prisoners in there as one of the prisoners there.
Oh.
The one that wasn't a hassle.
So she's a mother. Of that's her child. Ooh,
yes.
Awkward.
Scandalous. All
right, do we?
For here.
Yeah, do we want to send the ladies out through the other door?
No, what? They're going with us.
They're coming with us.
Okay, come on, let's go, ladies.
Come this way, and then we can loot this area because we haven't done that.
Okay.
Okay.
Frank wants to check on their well-being.
Wait, what? Frank suddenly cares about them?
No, I want to make sure that they're either dead
Frank's
or still in here.
Right?
So,
they should either be dead or
you're,
run away.
You're looking around the this room.
The warehouse here, yeah.
In all of the empty, not empty, in all of the barrels and stuff, you just see food rations like salted pork, stuff like that.
Are these still here?
They are asleep, but yes.
Okay.
Is one asleep?
They had a rough day, okay?
I suppose.
I get that.
And they've got two big guards.
As you creak open the door, the guy who you, like, see was very heavily injured sort of, like, jolts awake and then immediately regrets it as the pain returns to his shoulder. Collapses nice. Back on the bed.
Excellent. All right.
I'm happy.
Let me continue out. I'll take the ladies in the rear. Not like that. Not like that. I mean.
Oh my God. Ladies and gentlemen.
All right. Single ladies.
You exit the mansion through the what would have been the front entrance, and you arrive at a sort of trapdoor at the back of the mansion at the top of the hill.
Oh, cool. We're outside. Can I see any tracks of a wizard, perhaps? I know what wizard tracks are. They have really pointy shoes.
I'm going to do this as well, I guess.
Perception?
Yeah.
18.
So, you see that this is by far the more common of the two entrances. So there are actually a lot of trails of footprints going in and out from it. Mm-hmm. You are not entirely familiar with...
Someone looked like they were leaving in a rush, though, right?
Certainly seem to be like a few tracks that are more spaced out than some of the others, but... You don't discern anything from the shape of the footprints themselves.
Okay.
First, you don't even know this guy. You haven't seen him. You don't know what his shoes look like.
Yeah, but were there tracks that look like... There are tracks that look like they're going faster. Which way do those look like they're going?
Away from the doorway.
Which direction?
They look
like to where? West,
they
east?
They look like they're... They look like they're headed, like, around the manor, and then as soon as they get to the main road, they just disappear.
Okay. What? Okay, well, I guess, guy's probably gone, right?
I mean, we were in there a while.
Yeah.
Doing all sorts of nonsense.
You want to go back to the inn?
I mean, I suppose. we should escort these ladies back to their places because
of course.
The red brand might notice that they're with their captives.
All right, so let's sneak over to Alderleaf.
Red like capes, by the way, so they may not immediately make the connection, but I don't know.
Okay, yeah, let's.
So is one of the prisoners.
True. Whatever. Let's just escort these ladies. Let's escort the halfling girl back to Alderleaf Farm. Let's start with that.
I'm gonna take off my cloak.
So you bring the girl back to Quilline Alderleaf, and she thanks you kindly, and she's glad to have her daughter back. Thank you so much. Is there anything I can do to repay you? I don't have much, but I do run a farm, if you're ever in the need for food.
Well,
in that regard.
I'm parched, honestly. Good meal could do us all some good.
Come in, have a drink. Let's see, what do we got here? There's always water from the well.
Could have
some wine, but I've been trying to save that for a special occasion. But you know what? Getting my daughter back is quite a special occasion. If you would like a glass of wine, I could offer.
I would love that, ma'am. That is much appreciated. And any sort of food as well, just a snack.
Okay, so you go inside. You get she sort of makes you a meal, like as thanks for getting her daughter back, and there's a glass of wine for everyone. And at the end of it, the bottle has run dry.
Okay. I turn to the Alderleaf halfling farmer woman and I say, "So tell me, is there a Mr. Alderleaf?"
She sort of looks at you and says, "Yes, there is."
I go, "Well, I'm sure he'll be happy to have his daughter back as well."
Break that. Be like, do you think now that we've gotten some proof, the townmaster might do something, or might, you know, at least admit that he was wrong?
I certainly hope so.
We should probably confront him about this.
Proof, though, you say.
Well,
certainly.
Actually,
you have the eyewitness accounts from my daughter, certainly, and those two young women. I haven't actually seen them around here. Who are you? They all sort of like start introducing themselves and making small talk about where they came from, mm-hmm. Thunder Tree, what happened, Red Brands have taken them in, like, as captives, and then you freed them.
Yep.
Okay.
Nice.
They're all freed now. Okay. So do we have any, like, honest to goodness proof we can show the townmaster? What kind of evidence do we have?
I can't hear you that well.
Do we have any honest to goodness proof of the what's going on? Did we take that letter with us, by the way?
We did.
I'm sure you did.
All right. Mm-hmm. I say, well, we have this. I'd say we have this letter. I think we should go to the townmaster's hall and confront him.
She sort of like looks at the letter and sort of grabs it from you, not forcefully by any means, and sort of reads it over and says, Oh, yeah. That would do it. That better knock some sense right into him.
Good to hear. Thank you, ma'am, for your meal, and I'm glad that you were able to get your daughter back.
It's no trouble. Seriously, come back anytime. I'm more than happy. I owe you a great debt today for what you've done. Thank you again.
You're a lovely woman, and your husband is a lucky man.
Oh dear.
Yes.
Oh dear.
Thank you. Yes.
As usual, I'm going to hit Speedy with my staff a little bit, just a little bonk.
Thank you.
You take 1 point of bludgeoning non-lethal damage.
Okay.
Is it gonna keep getting harder the more you do this?
Hey, it worked the first time. Let's go to the Town Master's Hall, you guys.
I will say it is midnight.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Let's go to the inn and get some sleep, guys.
Both in game and out.
Yeah. Yeah.
So yeah, you go to the inn. The two guys are the two guys who happen to be like restrained in your room are still restrained and unconscious, though in different positions and have different wounds that would have brought them to unconsciousness. Kaylin, as soon as you enter the room, is just like, oh, what took you so long?
Well, it's been quite the trip, Kaylin. I'll tell you about it over a drink or something. But for now, let's get some rest. And that is it for the episode.
End scene. I will talk to you all separately over Discord and stuff to tell you how much experience you got from the dungeon and all that. But
cool.
Certainly it should be enough to level you all up to 3 if you want to take that.
Did we get any experience from last week or no? Because we didn't ever discuss that.
Oh, true.
I'll factor that in.
Okay. And, Frank, well, now that we've saved the hostages from Trezendar Manor and from the Red Brand, I suppose it's you'll be wanting to go now.
Yeah, sticking around here probably.
Who are you talking to?
Frank.
Oh, Frank. Right.
He's gonna make a new life for himself, you know.
Yeah.
Good old Frank.
You already took my damn jacket. Keep it.
I hope you make an honest living. I hope
probably
you
end up a mercenary, I'm not gonna lie.
You know what? That's at least a little bit more honest than what you were doing.
Yeah.
Isn't that the same thing?
I mean, before you were, you know, a gangster. Now you can be a soldier for hire. You can work for good people too. I hope that you will. But in the meantime, enjoy your life. It's been a good episode. I'm gonna end this with some shout-outs for everyone who's been playing with us. I'd realized that I haven't been doing that very much for the previous episodes. So we have, as our DM, the wonderful Steve, a.k.a. the other guy, 52, question mark?
Yeah, 52.
The other guy, 52, on Twitch. You don't stream, but he's
not
a cool guy. Then we have, as Milo Applebottom, Mr. Ben is able. Ben is also a streamer, right, Ben?
Yes.
Sometimes.
Even though I haven't streamed in
come all on. These fantastic people over here.
Yeah, but Ben's pretty new to streaming, but he's really cool, really fun to watch, so give him a check him out sometime. And then we have Pete Love and Understanding, Pablando.
Yo. I haven't been streaming like
so long after
the last week because I've been bogged down with schoolwork and other things, but I'm going to start streaming starting tomorrow, so back up again.
Yeah, you've been playing some Pokemon.
Yeah, get back to that. Sun and Moon.
Woo. Pokemon S&M. And then we have, as Frank.
Please don't say that ever again.
It's too late. Pokemon S&M, they made it. I don't make the rules. Then we have, as Frank, we have Dead Samish. Dead Samish, you also stream sometimes, correct?
I have streamed twice in my entire lifetime, but if you give me a caster command, it will Rickroll you.
It's happening anyways.
Yeah!
He'll stream again sometime, I know it. And then, as Noah the Foreigner, we have Spivey.
Yep.
Yeah. You were looking into streaming at some point, correct?
Yeah, maybe next year.
Yeah.
Because I go away soon for a couple of months, and it just won't work.
Oh, where are you going, man?
I'm going home.
Oh, okay.
I'll be playing stuff, but I'll, you know, won't have my setup.
Right, right. Okay, cool. But yeah, we are the Dungeon Runners. I am NotSoSpeedRuns, I'm a variety streamer, and this is my channel. I play a bunch of other games on it. But D&D is every Thursday at 8:30. So come back next week and we will have more of this. Thank you guys so much for coming out here and watching. Before we go, I'm going to go ahead and send you guys off on a raid, if that is all right with you guys. Who is online right now? You know what? We've got Lanthios online right now. Lanthios is how I met Dead Samish, and he's also like a really great streamer. One of the reasons I started. So let's go ahead and send a raid over to Lanthios. I'm gonna put the link in chat right now. So yeah, go ahead. We're gonna copy and paste that thing that I just put there. We're gonna go into his channel. I'm gonna host him, and then we're gonna spam the hell out of it on his channel. So thank you everyone so much for watching. It's been really fun. Thank you guys for coming out here and playing. Good night, everyone. And as always, don't forget to take it slow. Bye.
Woo!
Woo!
Are we at close?